Okay. Oh, whoops. I still have hotkeys on. What? An awesome way to start the show. Everybody in the pool. Well, it wasn't quite as awesome as normal, but they're still awesome. Thanks for hyping us up, Lacko and McKinley and Green Rabbit. Oh, man. He's got Baby Yoda versus Grimpen going on. He's got battles. Get a whole battles in the chat. No, Baby Yoda's got telekinesis powers, and he's 50 years old, at least. He acts like a baby. Yeah, maybe that's what they mean. Oh, shit.
Yeah. They can't hear Grimpen, baby. Now we can hear he you. Also decided to start calling me Primpen.
Oh, Primpen. Oh, Primpen. Primpen. That's what we call you.
Yeah.
We don't call you baby. We call you Primpen.
Yeah, I partied too hard. That's why I can't talk. I did some crazy body mods while I was out partying, and now...
Lost your voice completely for a second there.
Lost it completely, but
couldn't
then
even make like a whisper sound.
Dr. Pants
it
did
was
it.
Total
you
mute.
You think there's someone out there named Dr. Pants?
I probably, oh man. I would have... If your name is, if your last name is Pants, I just don't become a doctor.
But then there's probably a Captain Pants.
That would be great. I'd trust the Captain Pants.
Huh. Yeah,
I don't think
I guess.
I'd go to Dr. Pants.
That's true. Although, if you needed a doctor for your pants, you go to Dr. Pants, the pants doctor.
Yeah, definitely then. Then.
But then I guess he's more of a sewer than he is.
And that's more his job description.
Yeah.
His name.
Right. That's true. I mean, I love the world where everyone's last name was just what their family did as a job.
Yeah. Barrel maker.
And it would be so much funnier in a world where people do streaming on the internet now. And like, yeah. Like, yeah. Well, what if your family was like a porn star family? Would you be like the Fuckmasters? It'd be a great name, a great last name. Or it would just be the Fuckstons. Probably that's it. Yeah. Hi, I'm David Fuckston. Pleased to meet you.
And you would just know that. What they did, and
yeah, you'd know not to shake their hand unless you saw them wash it.
Exactly.
Yeah,
it's great. It tells you everything you need to know. Green Rabbit says there's a streamer named Dr. McFunky Pants.
See, is that Dr. McFunky Pants or is it Dr. MC Funky
Pants?
Oh,
that's a
good
question.
Is he both a doctor and a master of ceremonies?
Maybe he's a DJ.
Oh,
because funky, he's funky too. So.
It's true.
Man, like us, how's the week till now? What day is it? Wednesday? Oh, man.
Why? It's Wednesday? I don't know what's happened to the week.
Man, weeks are long these days. So long.
Yeah.
I just played lots of video games this week, though. I haven't actually done much.
I'm out of games again. It sucks.
No.
This is my peaks and valleys way of living.
Because if people's names were based on jobs, would prostitutes be the Herpes Sons?
Maybe, but I feel like less than 50% of prostitutes have herpes.
It'd be like Johnny Hay Sailor.
Oh, there you go.
It'd be
the
Hay
Sailors.
Yeah, it'd be Bethany Hay Sailor.
Oh, man. That'd be very good.
Green Rabbit says, my buddy's last name is Bullscock.
That poor guy.
Told him his destiny was porn. Man, you could really go far with a name like that. In porn, for sure.
It's true. Like, yeah. Oh, man. The problem is you're never going to live up to your name, even if you do have the materials to do so. It's just, it just can't be done. No one wants to be the bull's cock.
Yeah. Yeah, that is a high standard to keep consistently.
Green Rabbit wants to embrace it. Yeah, oh, totally. I would definitely get a lot more sports jerseys in my life and just get my name on the back of them. Like, oh, yeah, there's my Manchester United Bullscock jersey and my Oilers Bullscock jersey.
It's really great because it sounds like you can, like, You could just swear all the time.
Totally. And you're just saying your name.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Make people angry at you. And they go, Bulls cock.
Bulls cock.
That'd be fantastic.
Yeah. Oh, man. You got to hook us up with your friend, Green Rabbit. Like, just so we can say his name.
His Prinny Collector's Edition. That's pretty cool.
Oh, gosh.
I did see a post about it. It's pretty elaborate. There's tons of stuff in there.
Is it both Prinnies?
Yeah.
Maybe
that's not. Maybe they're not together. I don't know.
Right. It's stupid that you have to buy them separate on digitally.
Anyone named Woody is destined for porn as well, says McKinley. So now, parents should have gone just full all for it and gone Woody Bullcock.
The problem is there's no one who's actually named Woody. They're all Woodrows.
Yeah, but you can.
But then Richards are also, you can say, are all destined for porn as well.
Wow.
All those dicks.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's only so many jobs in pornography, is all I'm saying.
So many jobs? Right.
Jobs in porn, yeah.
Yeah.
If every Woody, Dick, and Harry needs those jobs.
Right.
So,
yeah, there'd be someone named like Harry Fluffer.
Oh, that's perfect. But then, like, a fluffer, isn't that, that's like an off-camera job when you're in porn, isn't it?
Yeah. I thought we were still talking about this world where everyone's named after what they do.
That's true. That's genius.
Yeah.
I bet there are fluffers out there, though. Like, there's got to be people whose last name is Fluffer.
Probably. I mean, there might be a Harry Fluffer out there.
I wish I had a white pages sitting next to me that I could flip through as we were talking about this.
Yeah.
Well, for like Los Angeles and New York or something. Pages. Oh, yeah. That would be even better.
Yeah.
Green Rabbit seems to think the worst job is probably a porn janitor. I mean, I'd probably rather be a porn janitor than like a hotel room cleaner. I think that's got to be the grossest job that's out there. Because then you're getting all the porn cleaning up after, but then a lot of other worse stuff.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like porn might be is more. I don't think hotels are like consistently as gross as cleaning up porn.
The stories you hear, I don't know. You don't hear stories from porn janitors.
Porn janitor is a thing. Pretty sure it's just like one of the crew members.
Maybe not. Did Mike Rowe ever do that episode of Dirty Jobs? I'm just mopping up after this porn shoot today.
I mean, somebody's got to do that. Somebody's got to do some mopping. I just don't think it's like a dedicated position.
Yeah. Oh, Green Rabbit's grandfather was a prawn janitor, so he cleaned up shrimp. Yeah.
All right, fine.
Are there porn screenwriters out there, you think? Are there porn screenwriters out there, you think?
Yeah, probably.
I doubt it. I don't know. Those scripts have just got to be come up with just off the top of their heads.
I mean, they probably had other job. They probably were like the janitors.
Like, what's the thing? Isn't it? It's the black book scripts in Hollywood, where like all the best scripts they pull from this list of scripts. Do they have that for porn? Here's just all the best scripts this year.
I doubt it's that lucrative. It can't be that competitive.
Yeah, that's true.
Because like. Otherwise, I don't know. I'd be like more like I'd write porn if it was like
it'd be easy.
Yeah,
like McKinley says, there's probably screenwriters for the multi-hour porn parodies, but that not really. That's just people sitting there watching the Marvel movie and like transcribing it and just switching out words for dirty words.
Yeah. I don't know that it's the like. Yeah, I think it's probably just like the director of the of it.
Or, yeah,
now, there probably or the is star. A writer,
and I think this is all the same person.
Yeah, it's probably all the same person, exactly. They're probably starring it.
And they're the producer, yeah.
And the owner of the company. Hmm.
Yeah.
Your nurses are probably used to when porn was on the big screen.
I can't even imagine.
Style.
That's such a nuts concept to me. That's such a... I can't imagine ever wanting to go and see that.
Well, I don't get going to it. Yeah,
it's sure. Just gross. Yeah,
but I understand that it's like there's a lot of things that people do that I.
Oh yeah, that I don't get.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fair.
I would do. Yeah. But, yeah. It is very weird. It's a very old person thing for sure. I feel like
totally. Paul Rubens was the last one to go.
And nobody born in the last 40 years has ever gone to a nudie.
a peep show.
The peep show, yeah. A nudie porn theater.
He says when it was on the big screen, did people just jack off in the crowded theater? No, you weren't even allowed to. That's the thing. Didn't Paul Rubens get arrested for doing just that?
Fred Willard did.
Oh, Fred Willard. That's who it was. Yeah.
I think Paul Rubens did too. Oh, you're right. Yeah.
That's the craziest thing about it.
Yeah. Yeah. That's
not
the,
that I
was going to
sit in a theater full of a bunch of masturbating weirdos, but.
Yeah. And then, what did police just raid it sometimes or something? Or I don't understand.
Yeah. I wonder if there's going to be any people jerking off in here today.
We're gonna, every once in a while, we raid the nudie theater and we catch a few perverts in there.
Charge them $50 and kick them out.
Yeah. What did you, like, what? I don't know. Yeah. What was that? What was the point of them? Like, it's nice to see I've asked the topics change from gaming history to porn history.
It's all history, baby.
It's fascinating history.
It's true.
It's
I bet
confusing.
Yeah,
and, I have lots of questions.
They're gaming and porn have always been kind of adjacent, like niche hobbies. And like I remember when CES was like huge, they'd happen at the same time in Las Vegas as the adult show would happen, and you'd see like all these pictures of like John Carmack and Ron Jeremy drinking together, and like just weird shit.
It's bizarre.
It's insane. But then the problem is gaming has become mainstream and porn has stayed its weird, like, huge fucking niche, but still a really niche thing.
Yeah, I'd like to. It would be fun to see it cross over. Like Green Rabbit says, love to see a Clint Eastwood written and directed porn.
It would be insane. Like an actual auteur director doing weird.
Exactly. Just like a really good movie with. Just awkward.
Or why not
awkwardly
like,
long sex scenes?
Totally. Why not like Wes Anderson doing a stop start animation, a stop animation porn? It'd be so funny.
That's got to exist somewhere.
It's got to, but that's also.
There's multiple, like. Well, I guess, yeah. There, I think.
Like, once a video stops being for sexual purposes, it's
puppets.
Not porn anymore.
Puppet porn.
I don't know. Oh, like there's the puppet
Green
sex
Rabbit says
Team
Fritz
America.
The Cat. I guess there is like a line that we're talking
Fritz
about
the
here.
Cat fucked me up. That movie is.
Like it's the wrong games today. We should be talking. We should be playing Leisure Suit Larry.
That's true.
Yeah. Porn
Fritz the Cat
is niche,
maybe the most awful thing I've ever seen.
Like it's that's cartoon, not stop motion. There's got to be a stop motion one.
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm not looking it up. But like nobody's watching that for the purposes that people watch porn is the problem. So is it really porn anymore? Or is it just a weird
that's
crazy person?
I don't know. Yeah, like that's what I was kind of talking about too. Like it's some stop motion things probably walks that line too between actual porn and like
and just sexy art.
It's like yeah. The Green Rabbit says, what? It's groundbreaking. Without Fritz,
yeah, groundbreaking isn't ever. Groundbreaking is almost never good.
Well, and I think Griffin just watched it when he was too young.
Way too young.
Yeah.
That was the problem. Yeah. Like sometimes Bravo would show really cool movies late at night, but then sometimes you'd flip it on and it would just be nonsense. Just be like a bunch of Swedish people naked dancing in a field, or Fritz the Cat, or the weird I don't know. Oh yeah, it might have been Wicker Man. I've never seen the original Wicker Man.
McKinley says stop motion claymation porn must be a fetish. So hi, Tiny Observer. You come at a perfect time, perfect moment here.
I don't know if that's a fetish. It's just naked claymation at that point. Like, I don't know. I feel like there are people with degrees who are supposed to talk about these things. We're not smart enough.
Probably fetish degrees. Yeah. We'll have to go back to school.
Oh, that would be great. I have a degree in stop motion animation pornography.
And Muppet porn.
Oh, man.
Good. A plus in Muppet porn.
Viewing or watching?
Oh,
or
it's like all you study it. The whole class, yeah. Yeah, like there's Meet the Feebles from Peter Jackson, yeah. And then there's then there's the one more recently from Jim Henson's son.
What?
That had, I can't remember. It was like the murder mystery one with Melissa McCarthy and stuff. Can't remember
and
what
it was
called.
Motion?
No, it was Muppets.
Oh, yeah.
That right. had nudity and sex in it and stuff. But I know from like, I follow a cult film group and there is like a full on puppet porn out there too. I believe it's called Let My Puppets Come.
That's pretty good. But there's also, what was the Robin, oh, Death to Smoochie probably has some nudity in it. Remember Death to Smoochie?
Yeah, but what does that have to do with anything? Like puppet nudity?
I don't know, I bet there's also puppet nudity in that.
Maybe.
Germany, they say pornoros, which means awesome.
This is every stream here is porn.
I mean, from the right angle, it's all about perspective.
I don't know what school. Oh, there's probably some school that teaches everything.
There's got to be.
Get some
there's,
class.
If there's clown, if there's clown college, there's every other kind of school.
Fetish college.
Yeah.
Green Rabbit would watch Grimpen porn. Well, you should make some if you have any artistic
ability.
No,
that's okay.
I feel like that's when we really made it, is when somebody starts drawing porn of us.
Oh, yeah, doing the Grimpen parody porn.
Yeah, that's when you really...
Yeah, when I can find a pregnant drawing of me on the internet, then I know we've made it.
A drawing of you pregnant?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Just keep in mind, everyone, that Grimpen's bottom half is tentacles.
Yeah,
you never
exactly.
see it because it's disgusting, but you can just use your imagination.
Just use your imagination. That's plenty.
Yeah. Oh, no. Tiny Observer wants to watch Meet the Feebles.
What is Meet the Feebles? What was that movie?
That's Peter Jackson. And that's
well,
like
what is it? Is it like crazy looking? I'm Googling
it's
it.
Just, yeah, it's like a disturbing. It's kind of the Fritz the Cat of puppets. I've never seen it. But I just know.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. I'm familiar with this. Yeah. Once you see pictures, it's.
It's nice. Right. It's yeah. It's a very adult, visually, disturbing movie.
Wow, interesting.
Oh yeah, like it says, his second movie. He believes that's correct.
I'm just looking at the screenplay credits. It's written in New Zealand, and one of the people who wrote on this movie is a name I could never even pronounce. It's just all letters I've never seen before.
Like it says, he was banned in Germany, so you had to import it.
Oh, cool.
From Austria.
I'm going to have to check out Meet the Feebles.
Is there didn't know what it was? Oh, God. That's
that
like,
would be startling.
There should be like a warning that plays on that movie the whole way through for kids.
Totally. Okay. It says people that also watched a lot of movies that I do really like, so that's kind of concerning. Brain Dead and Bad Taste and
well, Bad Taste Brightener Jackson as well. He is his height of grinding.
The height of when he was
this
before he got big.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. We're talking about hentai in the chat now.
I was going to say, yeah.
Yes, Brain Dead is awesome, Lackalith. You are 100% on the money with that.
I've never seen that either.
It's great. I mean, I think Brain Dead, yeah, it's... What's the other movie that has the cover that looks exactly like Brain Dead? And I swear it's also a Peter Jackson movie.
I don't know. Let me see the cover of Brain Dead.
Oh, gosh. Is it Dead Alive? Is Dead Alive Peter Jackson? Or is Dead Alive and Brain Dead the same thing? It is. Okay, that's why I'm going crazy. That's why they have the same cover. Yeah. Have you seen Dead Alive?
No.
Oh, there's rumors that Jackson's bringing his old movies back in 4K. That's weird. It's crazy seeing any old movie, especially one that was like made for $45,000 back in the day.
Yeah,
like,
sometimes
crazy 4K.
Sometimes it's worse, although it depends. Like, it's like different.
Yeah,
but it's like it's more
not,
like you're there on set, like seeing all the props and
totally.
Stuff, which takes you out of it. But maybe that's okay if you've seen it a million times. You might like something different.
Yeah.
Tiny Observer asks, what's Brain Dead, a horror?
Yeah.
The lack of Dead or Alive, the trashy movie about the video game? No. Like, what does that mean? So it was called Brain Dead everywhere else.
It must have been called Brain Dead internationally. And
but
Canada, it's called Brain Dead. And
in,
then,
just in the United States, it was called, for whatever reason, it was called Dead Alive. It's, is it Peter Jackson's first movie?
I always thought it was his first movie, but I think Bad Taste might be before Dead Alive.
It was, yeah. So Peter Jackson, who directed the Lord of the Rings movies, that's what really blew him up.
Yeah.
You know, so he's
huge
now.
Is that what blew him up?
Well, yeah.
Is that his?
Wow. I mean, Heavenly Creatures was his big mainstream movie, his first mainstream movie. I've never seen that either. That's supposed to be amazing.
I bought that once upon a time, and I've still never watched it.
I've heard insanely good things.
It looks pretty cool. It has a really cool visual style to it.
But his first three movies were Bad Taste, Meet the Feebles, which you've seen, and the zombie comedy Brain Dead. So he was like, he did lots of like Grindhouse, like.
Yeah, I should really watch Heavenly Creatures, because it turns out I actually really like his early movies. Maybe I just like Peter Jackson a lot, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, except that. What did he do? Like, I don't know, Lovely Bones? I think I saw that.
The Frighteners is great. Lovely Bones, Stanley Tucci was a grade A creep in that movie.
Yeah, he was super, super creepy.
Yeah. I liked King Kong when I saw it. It was fun.
Yeah, it was all right.
Like we were like high
school. And then you came back and did the Hobbits. That's what really.
I've still never even seen a Hobbit movie.
That's what's really thrown them under now.
Yeah.
Remember the Tintin movies when that was supposed to be a thing?
Oh, they were going to do the trilogy.
Yeah.
And it was going to be Steven Spielberg first, then Peter Jackson, then Peter Jackson and Steven Spielberg.
Something like that. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. It would have been fucking crazy.
I know, and I liked the first one that Spielberg did.
I love Tintin. It's endlessly rewatchable.
Yeah.
But it's, in my mind, it's no better than the old cartoon of Tintin.
Andy Serkis is so good as the captain in that.
Yeah.
Movie?
Yeah. Oh, it's true. Yeah. But then, like, I wanted more Tintin also. Like, the professor wasn't in it at all, was he?
Yeah. But there was supposed to be more.
It was supposed to be a trilogy.
They
blew
it. And they just kept talking about it. I feel like they never stopped saying it's going to come.
Yeah,
but I don't think it's.
And then Tintin.
What?
Like, I thought Tintin made a lot of money and stuff.
Oh, I thought we. I think we lost you for a second there. So.
Oh, weird. I don't know.
Yeah, I thought
I'm here now.
Good.
Yeah, although that's also one of those things. Like, they were gonna do multiple of the Last Airbender movies, and that first Last Airbender movie made so much money, and that's never gonna happen.
Yeah, but that was also hated though. Now the creators dropped out of the live action series too, but Tiny Observer loves the Frighteners, so there you go. You know some
Frighteners is also great, But Brain Dead's not violent; it's just gross.
And like I says, Heavenly Creatures is totally different from the first one.
Heavenly Creatures is two girls
Kate Winslet
conspire to kill their parents, right?
I don't know. I know it's like a more of a crime thriller movie.
It's like a Heathers kind of situation. But I don't know. Yeah, I should really just watch it. I've got it. Huh. Well, there you go. Someday.
Oh, like I said, no, there's tons of gallons of fake blood in Brain Dead.
Yeah. That's the thing. It's all stuff being like ripped open, not like fighting.
It's not violent though.
No, exactly. It's just awful.
Gore. I think that's the same thing, as far as
maybe.
I don't think Tiny Observer is like afraid of people fighting.
Right. Just doesn't want to see all the nasty.
Just don't stop hitting each other.
McKinley asked this earlier, but I just ran upon it on my phone. There's a trailer for the new Animaniacs that just came out.
Oh, yeah.
Which looks
I still haven't seen the trailer. I'm sure, yeah, it probably does.
My interest is very limited in it, but that show, like, it's crazier looking than any of the animation reboots so far. Like, it looks more on drugs.
Oh, yeah.
Than DuckTales or any of those ones.
That's intriguing.
That should be good. Yeah. Well, then DuckTales has a Darkwing Duck episode that just aired.
Yeah, I guess it was like an hour long. Yeah, that's cool.
Crazy. And it's free for everybody to watch on the Disney app, apparently.
There you go. One of these days, just watch that show. Like I said, let's get back to the... What?
There's going to be so much of that DuckTales by the time you get around to it.
Yeah, I was hoping it would end at some point.
Oh, yeah.
Like I said, let's get back to the real topic here. When are we going to play Frogger?
Oh, I thought it was pornography school. But okay.
It's the real topic. No, they voted for Shadow of the Colossus there, lack of. Ugh. Nobody, I mean, they actually Frogger tied with Grand Theft Auto.
But Frogger.
McKinley voted for, I think, Frogger and Grand Theft Auto. So it was basically my choice.
Your choice. Nobody likes Frogger.
Shadow of the Colossus won. Grand Theft Auto tied with Frogger for second place. If Frogger's on the Xbox, I could probably fit some in, but.
Frogger.
You're going to have to wait the whole show for that.
You're going to have to, sit there.
Lacko voted for Frogger because he knows the other games. Have you never played Frogger before? Takes about 5 minutes.
Yeah, you go from the top to bottom. First level's not that hard, but then it gets hard.
Oh, yeah, Lacko's played Frogger as well.
Ah, so his vote was disingenuous all around.
I mean, there's lots to talk about with Frogger. Didn't they, like, make a TV show at one point?
I don't know. They made a TV show of a lot of those bad things. Tiny Server says, do you guys not like Shadow? Oh, I don't like Shadow.
I like Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah. I don't
Have you ever it. Even really played
I don't...
it?
Yeah, I played it. Oh, yeah. I tried to play it when I worked at the game store. I own it. I hate the way it plays.
I'm not the biggest fan, but I actually my favorite of his games is The Last Guardian, the most recent one.
Yeah.
One. I like that a lot. It's still great. And it's great. I'm happy to play it and talk about it, especially with gaming history. It's like hugely significant in gaming history.
I suppose so. I think, yeah. He's only got the three games?
What?
He only's made the three games, Ico, Shadow, and... I don't like this game.
Sorry, I didn't know. No, not at all.
Vote for what you want, yeah. If I really couldn't stand seeing it, it wouldn't be on the list.
I'm glad at least I either wanted that or Grand Theft Auto to get the votes because I wanted it because those are the ones that I usually like to have one that I can like talk about a lot with gaming history. And Frogger I could have, but Frogger it's so repetitive.
Yeah, like
when he voted for Minesweeper back then, that's why he voted for Frogger, just to torture me. Exactly. That's why I chose Grand Theft Auto 3 as the other game. And they're both on the PS2, so I thought that was cool. We got two PS2 classics. Hugely, both of them hugely significant, influential games.
Totally. I mean, GTA 3 is about as influential as it gets in that generation.
Yeah, exactly. And Shadow of the Colossus is up there, too. Like, it was the one time where he could vote for Minesweeper, everyone did to torture me. It's true. That was out of control. That was like 7 people voted for Minesweeper.
That's nuts.
McKinley played a side-scrolling action-adventure platformer Frogger. Yeah, that's the other thing. They've tried to revive Frogger a bunch of times. I could have done like a tour of Frogger games. What even else was on the board? I can't remember.
I don't know. Yeah, remember when Atari did that whole thing where they made the Frogger side scroller? They made the weird, like, Pong Evolved. They did a bunch of, like, evolutions of their crazy old stuff for a little while. I think you had that Pong game, didn't you?
No, I think I don't know. I played it for sure. So maybe
I swear I remember playing it on your, like, home computer for some reason.
Oh, maybe I did. Yeah.
I think, yeah.
I think it came for free and something.
With, like, cereal or something.
Oh, yeah, the other games, there's no game that would have made Grimpen happy, Tiny Observer, so. Except for
GTA would have made him happy.
Yeah, which also we're playing anyway.
Exactly.
But, yeah, there's no other game that, so that gives you an idea of, yeah. Don't worry about what Grimpen thinks. He's going to hate most of the games.
Mostly. Enjoy. It's true. It should just be, every week should just be Binding of Isaac in gaming history. That game came out in the past, did you know? It's history. It's the most influential game ever.
It's somewhat influential. We've never
it
done
is
it.
At this point. Yeah.
And I think it came up a few weeks ago, but I didn't put it on because really you need to be here for that.
Nobody's going to vote for it either.
I'm not going to.
Alex might. But nobody else is going to vote for it.
Like I says, I don't care if Grim is happy. Because on the phone, I can't see if he's angry or not. Yeah, you can't get a read on
as
his expressions.
To other times, you can't see my smile or my frown. Yeah.
You didn't even have eyebrows in that picture of you on the phone. No, like,
it's tragic,
it's just
really.
Blank. Yeah, you know, you can't get any read. No body language. Usually you're just so animated.
That's how you can tell a sociopath, is they don't give off any body language.
It's true. But
yeah,
that would make everyone on the phone sociopaths.
I think that's the case.
They're not moving. I can't see them moving.
Oh, man. You could be thinking anything.
McKinley's Pong Sports Collection on the Atari was really fun. Actually, it's that Pong game wasn't bad, that like 3D Pong game. Like an adventure game.
No, because it was more like Breakout too, wasn't it?
Yeah, exactly. But you like progress through levels and stuff. Like it's
yeah.
You still play Pong, basically.
Yeah, Pong at its core is a great game.
It's true. Did you see that? Actually, just I think today or yesterday it was announced. Atari is making like portable Pong. It's a weird.
What?
Weirdly. Specific announcements is it looks like it's just Pong. It just plays Pong, but it's like a portable thing that you can bring around. That's like the old school thing that has the like knobs that you turn.
So it's like a miniature game console, like the mini NES, but for just Pong.
For just Pong, exactly.
That's crazy. Like that's really how it was played though too. Didn't people buy it at like Sears? You'd get like just the Pong machine.
I think so. Yeah.
It just makes me think of remember that episode of that 70s show. Where Kelso and Red modded their Pong game. Let's just make it go really fast.
Oh, I forgot about that.
I guess I'm the only one with that.
The cool thing to do, probably.
Yeah, totally.
Nice is your picture. Your Griffith's picture is always smiling, so I guess he's okay with everything. Yeah.
Is that a smile?
I think so, yeah. It could be interpreted
That's
as
also.
One.
It's the look I make when I'm in pain as well.
Yeah, but I always find, I don't know, I always look at like billboards and stuff and the smiles people have on them, and I always find it's like,
yeah,
if you just look at it and slightly differently, they look like they're in horrible pain instead.
It's true.
And like
those poor people on billboards, they're trapped up there.
Yeah, exactly, in that pose forever. Laco got some Pong games. One for the DS, one for the PS4. Yeah, they keep making them.
As long as people keep buying them.
I should look at when Pong came out. I don't know if I ever wrote that down.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's one on our. It's in our intro. Speaking of which, we should get to that.
Get to our intro?
Yeah. Play some of these crazy games.
Yeah.
Guys, both of them I think will be pretty fun to play. I'm going to enjoy putting some time into both
totally.
Of them.
Totally.
So.
Yeah.
I'm going to take a super quick break first, though.
Let's do it.
So we talk for too long. All right.
Let's play.
We'll be right back.
Nice.
This week in gaming history. Shampoo.
Shampoo.
Colossus.
Yeah.
Time for gaming history. Man. And Shadow of the Colossus.
What was Frank's stripper girlfriend name in Always Sunny in Philadelphia? Was it Shampoo? I don't think so. It was something stupid like that.
Like, this is finally some Frogger gameplay. Wait, that's not Frogger?
No. Yeah.
No, I think he just...
You play as Frogger trying to climb some traffic.
He was halfway through a beer and just smashed it on the ground.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Pizza!
Just make sure you lift that beer up off the floor.
Now he's just screaming about pizza. Well, we're playing some Shadow of the Colossus, because that's what won Lacko.
Screaming nice about pizza is a fantastic name for a cookbook.
Yes, definitely. All cooks out there, write that down.
Yeah, write that down. Take that pizza cookbook.
Yeah, because that's a business opportunity right there. It's a $1 million idea.
$1 million idea. It's all in the titling.
Yeah, it's Shadow of the Colossus. This game came out on October 18th, 2005. Actually came out in North America first, October 18th, 2005. It came out in Japan just a week and a half later on October 27th. And then a few months later in Europe and Australia. Europe and Australia, I guess, got it in like a cardboard case. Because it was like a budget game or something.
Weird.
Something like that.
Was it Sony published everywhere?
Yeah.
Hmm, interesting.
Published by Sony, developed by SIE Japan Studio and Team Ico. Team Ico, of course, known for the cult hit game Ico, also on the PS2.
Yeah.
Yeah, this game is huge, though. Ico was kind of a cult hit, like I just said, but then Sony really marketed this game. They marketed the hell out of this game, and it was not only a critical, huge critical hit, but a huge commercial hit for them as well.
Yeah.
So, it became really popular, and is now regarded as one of the best games of all time. It's one of the games, it's famously one of the games that you'll see always come up when games are talked about, whether or not games are art. People will almost always bring up this game. Mostly because of its minimalist
Aesthetic. Dialogue doesn't make it not art.
It's very, I'm very much in the camp that games are art, pretty much no matter what.
Games are art no matter what you do. It takes artistic prowess to
do it. Exactly. But people refer to this game specifically because it does go against what a lot of games do. It's not like all the action's very sparse and intense in certain areas. And it's very emotional. The whole thing's based around making you feel shit.
Right, feel bad for killing these giant beasts.
Yeah, actually, there's a funny anecdote in the development story where it's the first time the development team saw saw the character kill the giant and sad music played, they all thought it was a mistake and they laughed.
Huh.
Because they were just so used to triumphant fanfare playing every time you kill a boss. In this game, it's just super sad every time.
But then, so how far into this game is it before you realize you're actually the bad guy? Or you're helping
it's
the bad guy?
Late, I think. I think so there's 16 colossi, I believe, and by about the 12th, it starts to get a little sinister, I think. And then on the last one, it's pretty clear. You're the bad guy. That was also one of the big... That's the big story twist.
You're not the bad guy as much as you're doing work for the bad guy.
You're doing the bad guy's bidding and releasing him from his prison.
Right.
Yeah, that's how Zero knows the scale of it and the big monsters. Yeah, that was also something that you didn't really see much of at the time. And that's it. Those are the only enemies in the game. Are the 16 bosses.
In my mind, just the existence of Breath of the Wild makes this game fully obsolete.
Chimes, did you guys see my sub? No, I didn't. That's weird. Oh, thanks for the sub, though.
Oh, crazy.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, we didn't get a fun me making noises.
Yeah.
I guess I could just go... Yeah.
Perfect. Oh, Alex is here. Welcome to some gaming history. It's also ambiguous if you're doing a good thing or not. Yeah, that's kind of true, too, because you are helping. Like, the whole thing, you're trying to help somebody who's dead and who is sacrificed.
Right. No one good gets sacrificed.
Lots of good people get sacrificed. That's sacrifice. Sacrificing is generally not a good, not the good thing.
You don't do it to the good guy. I guess you do it to people who don't deserve it necessarily, but not necessarily good guys.
Man, the presentation of the game was in a castle. Some game magazines were invented and reported about that. That's cool. Invited, sorry, and reported about that.
Huh.
Hey, thanks, Lacko. Well, I don't know what's going on. Whoa, Lacko.
Shared
get the sub. Wow, thanks, Lacko.
Whoa. He's just feeling all those Shadow of the Colossus vibes. Evidently, I'm the only one here who is not enjoying, who doesn't enjoy the game. Everyone else loves Shadow of the Colossus.
It's a great game.
It's Zelda.
You know what's interesting? They talked about it Zelda was definitely an inspiration for the team and for the lead designer, Fumito Ueda. I'm definitely probably butchering that, but that's he's the main mind behind Ico and Shadow Colossus.
Right.
But he talked about it being inspired by Zelda, but it being like kind of a reverse Zelda, where it's just because it's just the bosses.
Right. That's kind of what Breath of the Wild is, though.
It's kind of just
dungeon-style bosses.
I would say Breath of the Wild owes a lot to Shadow of the Colossus. Definitely inspired by Shadow of the Colossus.
Totally. I just take it one step further and say it made Shadow of the Colossus obsolete.
I don't know if that's true. I've always wanted to play the HD remake that they made for the PS4.
Totally.
That got great reviews as well. Came out 2018, I think, or 2017.
Yeah, I think it goes pretty cheap once in a while, but
yeah.
Yeah.
I've played this a long, long time ago. Way back when.
Did you do all the lizard hunting and stuff in it when you played it?
No.
Because you get things for hunting all the lizards, I'm pretty sure.
Interesting. I guess my memory card's in here because I have a new game on. Unless, I'm just gonna double check. Oh no, never mind.
Damn.
Oh. Yeah, never mind. I got my old one on here. 15 defeated. So I guess there's 15.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I could load. It looks like I did a new game plus.
What changes, you think? Do you get it? You don't get equipment, right?
I guess there are unlockables. There's costumes.
I know when finding the lizards, you get more stamina and stuff like that.
Ah.
Yeah, if you get a certain amount.
All right, let's load it. It says zero. I'm assuming it's at the very beginning.
Is it fully open, or do you have to tackle them in a certain order?
I think you have to tackle them in a certain order. I think you hold your sword up.
Oh, right, yeah. It's weird, because remember fighting against the bird monster. I did play that part at very least. So unless it starts with that, I got at least a little bit into the game.
Yeah, I don't think that's the first one, but I don't know how many in it is.
Huh.
Like I said, there's nearly no interface. Yeah, that's pretty cool. It's very, focused on atmosphere and the art for sure.
DC Junkie's also here to lend his support for this game. Come on, people.
DC Junkie.
I didn't know everyone could all be so wrong.
Yeah, you didn't know everyone loves Shadow of the Colossus?
I mean, I definitely did know everyone loves Shadow of the Colossus, but
we love it.
Doesn't make you any less wrong.
It's crazy too. It's I was reading about it. I totally forgot about this until I was reading about it, but it was in a movie.
What?
It was actually used as a plot device in the movie.
You're not just going to say that weird Final Fantasy 15 movie, right?
Reign Over Me.
I don't know what that is.
It starred Adam Sandler.
What?
Yeah. I never saw it. But I remember getting decent reviews, but it's supposed to be very emotional because it's about a guy who lost his family in September 11th.
Uh-huh.
And Don Cheadle's his old friend.
Yeah.
And helps him go through some emotional stuff. But throughout the movie, he plays Shadow of the Colossus. And
weird.
The whole, I guess even the idea of the Colossi falling, kind of mimic his struggle with the towers falling and stuff. And it actually plays a major plot point in the game.
That's really something.
And I guess, and also the theme of a character trying to resurrect his deceased loved one, which is happening right now.
Oh, you're reviving your deceased loved one?
Well, that's what this character's name is Wander.
And he has a sweet horse.
Yeah. A horse, I believe his name is Argo?
I thought it was, yeah, something like that. Doesn't he just go, Argo?
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, it's Argo. DC Jungie loves Colossi. They're very cool designs as well. He's got the platinum PS4 version. Laka says there wouldn't even know Frogger gameplay today, DC Junkie. But I hope Colossi's good enough.
It'll have to do. Tiny Observer says I might be the wrong one here.
Shocking.
Yeah, okay. You guys are all just trying to gaslight me.
Whoa, this is freaky too. It's got a great aesthetic. I love the world that Oida created with Aiko, because they're all kind of connected.
Totally. They all look the same.
Yeah, they've all definitely got similar. Yeah, it's like an ancient world.
They also all have like a weird kind of blown out style to them in their color.
Yeah.
Like everything's so bright. And, yeah,
that's definitely one of the visual marks of the three games as well.
It's interesting, style.
Lots of bloom effects.
Right. Their love is in bloom.
I don't know if anyone here has played. What did everyone think of Last Guardian?
Oh yeah,
I loved it.
That one
was so weird.
You made it sound fun but frustrating.
Yep, totally.
Yeah,
right? it was like going on an adventure with a cat. Basically, it would be fun but frustrating.
I'd be so into it if you could keep that cat after the adventure. That's the problem. It's once this game's over, this cat is just stuck in this game.
I need to keep
this cat.
You just end up loving it, yeah. There's no way you can't love that creature in that game. It's designed.
That's why it's so much sadder when they kill it.
They don't, though.
I know. I can't believe they don't. It's so crazy that they don't. Because the moment I saw that, I'm like, oh, they're going to kill that thing. They're going to make you love it, and then they're going to kill it.
Michael says, yeah, in Germany, it was like I was saying before, it was a cardboard case.
Yeah.
But it also had postcards with it and the soundtrack, and I believe it also had special features. It had a making of on the disc as well.
Sure. Does this game, do people love the soundtrack to this one?
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty well loved. Seems like it. Tiny Observers is the scene with Argo on the bridge. Yeah, that's kind of the famous. That's right at the end. The horse is like running across the bridge and it's not going to make it. And then you like jump and Argo goes down off the bridge and you think Argo's dead. But Argo's not dead, don't worry.
Argo's never dead.
Same as the creature from Last Guardian.
That's the thing. Trico. It turns out this guy doesn't know how to kill off animals.
I guess. He's got a soft heart.
That damn soft heart of his.
Like I said, the sad thing is at the times back then I was an Xbox and GameCube player. Oh. Missed so much good stuff. The PS2 was pretty amazing. PS2.
And I was Xbox GameCube.
So you were there with Laka.
PS2, but then when I bought into PS2, I bought into PS2 so big when I worked at the game store.
Mm. Right, just like a little later.
Like,
that was the thing.
At a certain point, that
the PS2's life was so long, too. Like,
so long, yeah.
Games.
And it had so many weird games on it.
Yes.
Like, and like, weird and bad, and that's my wheelhouse.
Right. Yeah.
And there was a lot of that. But then, it's overall, the PS2 has very few games I consider like all-time favorites of mine. Very few. Other than like Metal Gear Solid 3.
I'd have to think about it, but yeah. There's a ton that I love, though, that are like, yeah. But maybe not all-time favorites, you're right.
I owned like 20 Xbox games, but probably like 5 of those, I'd say, are top games of mine.
And a lot of games, though, on the PS2 are like the starts of franchises I love, like still. And
yeah.
Yeah, lots of fun memories with the PS2. Yeah, I'm excited to play some Grand Theft Auto soon too. I don't know if anyone loves this game and hasn't played Last Guardian. Check out Last Guardian.
Blacko, in Europe on the cardboard case, did you have they had awesome cover art, didn't they? Or was that just the Japanese one that had the amazing cover art?
I can only like, you know, the only one that's remember the Aiko cover art. Is really
where
cool.
Is that? Am I thinking of it where it's all zoomed out and it shows like a big bridge in the background? Is that Aiko?
Yeah, like a windmill. Yeah.
Oh, that's what I. Okay, let me.
Yeah, Aiko had some really cool art. I think it was the Japanese art, but it might have been the European art as well. Our Aiko art, box art was terrible. It was just like
it was so bad because those characters were really ugly in general.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like Shadow of the Colossus. And the Japanese box art for Shadow is pretty cool. But it's nothing. Nothing to write home about. Yeah, it's the Aiko box art. That's amazing.
Huh. Shadow of the Colossus, the cover was one of the first bosses. Oh, was it just the same as ours? Like this one up here?
I think so, yeah.
Back to play this year, a game for PS2 called Gregory's Horror Show.
That sounds great.
I don't know what that is. That sounds awesome. This is a super long intro.
Just, yeah. For a game with, like, no exposition otherwise.
I guess after this, it is pretty much just nothing at all.
Is there any blood when you kill the bad guys? Like, I know you stab it for a big weak.
If I remember, it's more like a smoke, kind of like, or like a black, like, ooze, but like steamy black ooze.
Steamy black ooze, I see. Yeah. You definitely die if you lose it. Everyone needs their steamy black ooze.
Yeah, but like I said, check out Last Guardian. It's because to me, it was the best of both worlds because it's like Aiko where you have a partner that you're leading through, but your partner's like a giant animal that's just insane, like just one of the best designed creatures I've ever seen in video games. Like totally. Somehow reminds you of every animal at certain points, like the sounds it makes and the way it moves and the parts of it.
Yeah,
it's very cool, and you can climb all over it. It's just this awesome pet, and it sometimes doesn't do what you want. It's awesome.
Does he have like a noise, like a dog barks and a cat meows?
He has lots of different noises. Sometimes it sounds, I remember being reminded of like lions and like birds. Ooh. And yeah.
That's pretty intense.
All right, this is crazy. Look at the way he runs.
Right off the bat, yeah.
It makes me want to play the HD remake a lot. Instantly.
Totally. Feel a lot fancier looking.
Where did our horse go? There he is. Argo!
That's the big issue with the PS2 generation is nothing held up.
It's true.
None of it looks pretty good much. Anymore, except for Persona 4.
There's probably some,
Persona 4 still looks great, yeah.
There you go, yeah. But it's like the exceptions for sure.
Yeah. Whereas like on the GameCube, everything still looks really good.
A lot of it, yeah, because they went cartoony. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
All right, now I forgot I have to hold up my sword.
Ooh.
What is that, man?
Point you in the direction.
That is. Whoa.
Alex earlier said killing all the lizard lets you climb the tower.
Oh, right. That's this whole secret thing. At the very end of the game, spoilers, because he revives her.
Yeah.
But at the cost of his own life, basically.
Right.
But then he like turns into like in the pool where he got like sucked into with the demon. There's like a baby, I think, or like, and so she takes the baby up to the tower, and there's like a garden up there. And if you get all the lizards, you have enough stamina to climb up there and see the garden before. Yeah, you just see it on your own.
So it's like seeing Yoshi on the top of Peach's castle.
Yeah, totally. Did we ever play Super Bonk? I don't know if I ever played Super Bonk, but I
played Bonk's Adventure. Yeah, Super Bonk, I never played. I played some Air Zonk. Air Zonk was pretty
they
good.
They were weird games. I don't know if we. Oh yeah, we played some Bonk on stream when we did the TurboGrafx launch
titles. Yeah, but then. the later Bong games are much better than the original, apparently.
Well,
so
that's
we,
a cool
we've only
way to do the map. You like zoom it. Like,
where's... Whoosh. Oh, yeah.
I can't... I should have been paying attention.
Do you want me to look up a guide for this as you go?
Maybe. I just need to know how to use my sword.
Oh, that... Okay, let's see.
Like, do you do the light sword thing with Jig?
Let me see.
Like, where's your green
square
uniform, Link?
L1 says view Colossus. D-pad change weapon. L2 camera set, R2 zoom.
Maybe I can do it
R1
course.
And triangle dart and roll. I don't see a button unless view Colossus is the button to push. I don't know.
Oh, maybe. Oh, yeah. I think so. And then, what is it? Oh, I did it. Yeah, L1 and circle, I think. See, like, that's awesome. Like, and I love how there's no, like there's no, no guide, and yet you still know exactly where to go because you just got this thing.
Yeah.
Like, but there's no, that's all you got. It's just nice. I love when games have like a built-in sort of compass feature.
Yeah. Oh, totally. It's like pre-Dead Space technology. It looks like you could start fires with that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's got a magnifying glass kind of look. Speaking of Last Guardian, though, that the character in that thing was named Trico. This game was originally called Nyko.
Really?
Yeah.
That's...
They just love Ico.
They really loved Ico, so we're just going to make every game derivative of it.
Oh, there we go. I did something. But I guess it's also like some wordplay in Japanese.
Because oh, clever.
Ni, I guess, is two.
Oh, yeah. Itch, ni, san. Yeah.
There you go.
That is very clever.
So they... Oh, I think I have to climb this. So, and this was originally developed to be a sequel to Ico.
I mean, it kind of is.
The code name was just... So, like, the wordplay was just literally Ico 2, or 2 Ico.
Yeah. Like, it might not be a direct sequel to Ico, but it's definitely a sequel to Ico.
Yeah, it's interesting. Yeah, like, Ueda considered it a sequel, personally. Right. But he was like, yeah. Functionally, it's not really a sequel. Weird. There's not really, like, any... Like, I guess the first trailer that they showed for the game...
Yeah.
Was pretty different. I don't know what to do, though. I'm totally stuck. It's so hard.
Oh, hell if I know. Yeah. So you just ride your horse towards the light?
Oh, no. I have to climb this thing. Oh. What? Yeah. I have to climb this.
Oh, yeah.
Wall. It looks like I can climb it. Can I jump off my horse, maybe?
You can tell this is... pre-Uncharted because it's not like a clearly marked out route you're going to take on the wall. Tiny was over asked, is Last Guardian on PC? I think it's PS4 exclusive.
I think it is just PS4, yeah. Yeah.
All their
Sony,
games on it, I guess.
Yeah, I think Sony owns Team Ico, basically.
Right. I'm so confused by what you're doing.
Although, you know what's next, though? For Ueda. Is Epic Games has funded entirely funded his next project in exchange for 50% of the sales.
Weird. Well, that game will get ludicrous amounts of hype and then take 10 years to come out.
It might come faster with Epic dollars.
With money. Yeah, that's true.
Oh.
It could happen.
Oh, shit. Is there some... Maybe I can jump off my horse onto something. I'm so Stuck.
Games are hard.
Oh, okay. I'll have to watch a walkthrough as I go. I should always do this.
It's true. It's the only way to guarantee you don't get stuck. Problem is, if you wander far enough off the path, that the walkthrough isn't useful anymore.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that, though.
Is it a huge open world in this game, or is it pretty small? Like, because with no enemies and no towns and no anything.
I think it's pretty big.
But isn't it kind of boring just riding all over the place with nothing there?
That was kind of my biggest complaint. Yeah.
Right.
But that's, you know, it's always got, so it got, always got super fun once you got to the Colossus.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess the original, like the original one had like the original trailer had a bunch of boys that looked like the kid from Ico, basically.
Huh. McKinley says Tiny Observer could probably get an emulator. There's definitely no PS4 emulators on PC right now. I think, yeah, it would be a lot of effort for minimal return. But I don't know.
Maybe I don't have to climb up this wall or something.
Or you can just go around?
I thought it told me to do that. I don't
know. You weren't paying attention at the time.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, that I guess that original trailer is also on the first... European release. Like, you can watch that. Oh.
So they got, like, a deluxe edition other than the crappy box.
Yeah, but I guess the box was even still nice. Like, it was still...
Oh. Well, then. What are they complaining about?
Seems like he's going a totally different way, though. So I have no idea what's happening.
What do you mean he's going a totally different? Oh, the video you're watching. Okay.
Yeah.
Huh. He doesn't want to just ride into this wall.
Well, like the thing seems to be pointing him in a different direction.
Oh, so I wonder if there are like three or four that are available right off the bat.
I don't know. I can only find ones of the remasters. I don't know what to do. Maybe I'll try to find a different way around here.
Oh yeah, that'll do. That'll hold all the secrets. Not even like there's specific geography to be on the lookout for. Yeah. I mean, it would look pretty cool to just see this kid riding around holding his glowing sword up in the air all over the place, even though he's hopelessly lost.
Yes, I hope it's entertaining for all of you.
It must be. You'd think they're so fucking big, you'd be able to just look. Maybe and
I guess as the sword shows the way. I know, it's showing me right into this wall.
Huh. I mean, the wall must be the Colossus. Did you beat the wall Colossus yet?
Horse go.
Where's my latex?
Where's my latex?
Where is it? That's the name of the first Colossus. My latex.
I don't know where my... Oh, there he is. Yeah, I know, Laco. Look. The light tells me to go here. I just can't figure out how to get up this wall. Laco loves the sound commands. That's awesome.
Can you not climb the wall?
Just discovered it. I just don't know how to get up.
Climbing a big thing.
Where do I get?
Oh yeah.
I'm just missing where I attach to something.
You can't just climb. You can't just climb on any surface.
I don't think so. Maybe I'm missing a grab button. Like I didn't really pay attention.
I think there is a grab button. Stand by. There might be a grab button. Oh, never mind. My phone's just not working at all. Cool. But somehow the Skype call is still connected. But I can't turn the screen on. All right. That's new.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, there's a grab button. I don't know. I'm pressing all these buttons that you recommend.
Let me get this manual up again.
It might just be my eyes, because like this is all just... Like I might just be missing. Yeah, exactly.
Isn't R2 grab?
He seems to try to grab when I do it, but he just still falls to the ground. Maybe I can grab this stuff. No.
Grab it.
Climb is R1 plus analog stick.
R1 go. Oh. Can I grab? Could I have always done that? Let me just see. No. Okay. I had to grab this stuff.
Huh.
I can climb this stuff.
Interesting.
Much easier. It's always something like that that gets me. Something super simple. That I just. Oh. Like, they may have told me how to play. I wasn't paying any attention. Oh, I see. I need to get over here. Nope. Climb now. Oh, there we go. Okay. Yeah, it's a little weird. Like it's kind of an odd choice. I get it, but it's
tasty bits of oats and chewy.
I did it. Tasty bits of oats and chewy.
You're the American Ninja Warrior now, dog.
But they have no music when you're exploring. It's just when you fight the Colossi.
Right. Yes.
Oh no, Wander.
I don't like the name Wander.
In the instruction book of that European one, it was mistranslated to Wanda.
Oh, that's way better.
McKinley wants a game where you play as a fly from the American debates and just go around sabotaging speeches.
The problem is, if sabotaging speeches is just landing on their head and doing nothing, that's not a fun game.
It would be fun if you were like different things.
Unless it's like Shadow of the Colossus and he's trying to shake you off the whole time and you have to hold on.
No, I think you have to like be you different things and you have to sabotage it without alerting the speech giver.
Oh yeah, that's true.
So you could just like show up in the background and stuff and...
There was the Mr. Mosquito game on PS2 where you were flies that terrorized a family.
What did I do wrong here? Oh, I have to just crawl here.
Yeah, Canada's still somewhat shut down. It's like optional measures in our city. But our city is now worse than it's ever been.
Yeah, it just keeps getting worse now, yeah. Where? Now what am I missing? Oh, can I do like a jump roll? Can I roll somehow? I can roll.
Oh yeah, dive and roll. Everything seems to involve R1 in some
It is weird. You like hold down R1 and then do other things.
Like there's a, if you hold R1 and then left or right and triangle while riding your horse, you lean off the sides of the horse. I don't know why you'd want to do that.
That's pretty cool. Just be a badass, I guess.
Mako says use the Konami code. I entering the Konami code, I've always hated on PlayStation because there's not a B and an A, so I don't know what.
Right. Takes a couple tries sometimes.
Yeah. Especially with, because in Japanese games, circle is forward and X is back, whereas in North American games,
with the PS5, they're changing that.
And they're changing it to all match North America, and Japanese people are ticked.
They're not happy, yeah, because I guess just because of their language and culture and stuff, it just makes perfect sense that
circle is
confirmed and X is back.
Why change it at this point?
Yeah.
Especially because you can literally go in, like, you can change your button mappings on PS4 anyways. Right. So, like,
yeah,
it's just going to be annoying for them.
I found the first Colossi, though. That was pretty sweet.
You did. Sneak up on it.
Lycos. I think Lycos talking about Mr. Mosquito. There's another obscure PS2 game. Whoa. Like, this is cool.
It really is. It looks great.
And this was cool back, like, very cool back in the day. I gotcha. Oh, I don't gotcha. Oh, I got his furry shins. Grab his furry shins. Oh, am I? Do I keep losing you?
No, I'm here.
Okay.
Yeah, it's. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I'm still here, I do believe.
I wish all boss fights started with climbing hairy shins.
Oh, they could.
Do I jump to his hand?
Don't shave their legs.
I think I gotta jump to his hand. Most bosses don't shave their legs, it's true. Oh, right. I only have like a meter, like a certain amount of hold strength. Oh, I fell off. He's got weird, like, hooves.
I think he's the devil, isn't he?
Oh, maybe. Oh, no, you know, well, the best explanation I can find for what the bad guy actually is.
Yeah.
Because his name is Dormin. Which is, apparently, backwards. Spells. Nimrod.
Oh.
Which is awesome. But it's apparently not calling him an idiot. It's
Nimrod is an ancient god, isn't it?
It's a reference to an ancient king. Who was like Noah's great grandson.
Well, there you go. Noah and his great Nimrod.
How did he jump off of this guy's shin? His hairy shin. That's another. I wish there's a guy out there named Harry Shin.
I mean, or whatever Harry Shin is backwards.
I don't know how to jump off of there.
McKinley wants us to fill the lack of music with the Doom soundtrack. So Lacko says today is the first DLC of the new Doom game. Yeah, the something of the ancient gods. And it looks like you're fighting your way up to heaven. That's what it sounded like. Could be a neat thing.
That's cool.
Yeah, I don't know much about it, but McKinley will be into that.
I have to jump to the other hairy shin.
Oh yeah.
He's trying to shake me.
You gotta find the hairy shear.
I don't know exactly how to jump off here. What am I missing now? Is there like another combo of R1 buttons I can use to jump directly backwards off of something? Oh, wait. Can I stab his shin? Maybe I can stab his shin.
Oh, does it take damage? I'm away from that page because I was trying to find cheats to see if the Konami code did anything. Let me keep looking.
Oh, I can't.
It doesn't seem like
I got
it.
His shin.
Oh.
Oh, damn it.
It's weak to shin stabbing.
That's right. I always go for the shins, people.
There's dive and roll, climb, stand up on the horse. That sounds useful. You have a zoom button, but no, that seems to be it.
Got his shin. Knocked him down.
Now he's he can't do anything. He's like a ladybug.
Fist? Oh shit, was that too slow? Did that break his other shin pad?
Might have. Oh, yeah. Is that his health bar at the top? That's still
yeah.
So full.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
I know. That's the thing. Like their whole, like he said, they're basically Zelda dungeons in reverse. Oh, there we go. I did a sweet jump, backwards jump. So I guess I just need to be, like, pushing off. I wonder if I can just keep stabbing his shin, though. I think I can. So he stays down for longer.
Right.
Shin stabber. That's what they should have called him.
The shin stabber?
Yeah.
It's way better than longer.
Oh, I see what I was screwing up. Maybe. I have to, like, there's something going on. Oh, there he fell down. Oh, can I keep? Oh, shit. Shit, I missed it again. I don't know what I'm supposed to do exactly.
When you're climbing him, it literally just looks like a tiny gray mass climbing a big black mass. Like, there's so little definition.
Where do you think I'm supposed to press the sword again? When this circle comes up? At the very end? Oh, he's
probably at the end.
He's
oh.
really shaking me.
Yeah.
Maybe
I mean, you're trying to kill him.
Maybe I have to fall off of him for a bit. No, he's just shaking me like a madman. Ow. I do like the way that he runs with his sword. I think that's probably how I'd run with a sword.
It's the fantasy equivalent of holding your pistol sideways.
I kind of, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I like it.
Wacko says, in the trailer, he climbs on the sword to the top. I don't know what you mean.
I do, yeah, I think I climb on the sword at some point.
Oh, he's got, oh, the boss of the Colossus' sword. I see, I see, I see, I see, I see. Right.
Oh. Yeah, maybe I can't stab his shin anymore. He's just shaking me constantly. As soon as I get on that shin. I do remember this being most of the game. It's like just figuring out how to kill them.
Yeah, that's true.
Them.
That's the puzzle. It's like giant punch-out.
Can I jump?
Are they all quite different looking from each other? Because for there to be 15, that's a
yeah.
lot.
Oh, yeah, they're pretty different. Well, I mean, like, the, yeah, most of them are animal types. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I got a stab his shin. Where do I go, though? Oh, I thought he was going to fall. Damn it.
Nope.
This isn't going to be right. He might kill me.
You still have like half health.
Oh no, I have like one hit. I just got hit.
Oh no.
As you said that. Oh no. Whoa, buddy.
What's the other meter? What is the giant circle?
That's my grab meter. Once it goes out, I can't grab anymore. But then I also, when I use my sword, it makes a circle in that circle.
Yeah.
He's down on one knee. Proposing to somebody.
Both Lacko and Tiny Observer are agreeing that the controls can be frustrating.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Especially learning them. Like, it's been so long.
Sure.
But that's Team Ico's biggest problem. It's always has been. And then always filled with frustrating moments. This is probably the least frustrating of three, actually. You don't have an AI partner to deal with.
That's true. Although does Last Guardian have like a proper tutorial in it?
Does Last Guardian play like a bit more? Yeah, maybe a bit more. Yeah,
modern
than this, yeah.
Yeah.
The remake of this probably has more of a tutorial.
I bet it's way improved in a lot of ways.
Okay, so I have to stab him twice in the shins. Then he falls down. Oh, then I can grab his butt. I got his butt.
You got his butt. It's all about that butt.
All about the butt. Once you get on the butt,
ride that butt.
So much from there. Now I'm on his back fanny pack.
Oh no.
That's good. You know what else is totally? Now that I'm playing this, because I'm playing it right now, but I can just definitely feel the inspiration. Horizon.
Oh, totally.
It's definitely inspired by this game.
For sure.
I think I can get over to his shoulder pad, or should I go over to that?
Oh
no, that looks that shoulder. I think he's got like an elbow pad on that arm. Whoa, there you go. Oh wait, maybe I can just climb up his back hair. Oh, whoa, he's
climb
trying to shake me
back
off.
Back hair.
Whoa, oh no, whoa. Oh, that was awesome. Get on the back hair, Wander. Yes, there you go. All right, here we go. This looks good. Mad at me.
Sick and wrong.
There's his big point.
Stab it.
He's trying to shake me off. And like that just is cool. I love how it zooms in when you as you go into that thing where he lifts up his sword.
Yeah, the sadistic.
There's the blood. It's a black oozy steam.
Foggy goop. McKinley asks if you've encountered the giant dinosaur robots that are basically map download locations. Yeah, you definitely have, haven't you?
Yeah, lots of those.
You're like in the home stretch on that game.
I think I'm on. No, I think I just got to the last.
Sick and wrong.
Right.
Sick and wrong. Uh-oh, can I not get him again? Here, he's just shaking me like crazy.
Oh no.
Oh yeah, here we go. Oh shit. Oh shit. I think I got him. Oh, maybe not.
Oh no.
I have to be either super quick and just get like little bits of damage.
Tiny Observer thinks that there are some people that enjoy the challenge of mastering bad controls. It's one of those weird things though, like this game has bad controls, but I bet by the end of the game you wouldn't think the controls are bad either.
Yeah, probably.
I don't find the controls at all bad in Dark Souls. I think they're perfectly fine, and you would say those are bad controls. Like
the
it's
mechanics
just...
are very clever. The way, like that, this whole grab system is actually pretty cool.
Totally. What other games let you climb up things like that?
Well, Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, is Grow Home? So is there some of that to Grow Home?
A little bit, yeah. Yeah, that sort of feeling of like holding onto something as you get kind of thrown around.
Like, and like really high up, and it's.
Yep.
Interesting.
Did it. Yeah, those giant dinosaur robots are exactly what I was thinking of that reminded me of finding this thing. McKinley wanted to do the scream sound right when it died, but it's hard with the scream tag. Oh, and I think it might have been.
It's hard to time that stuff.
Beat my first colossi.
The work of a true artist is timing that out.
Well, normally I would play the first game for a bit longer. But in this week in particular, we've got two just gigantically huge games.
Hugely gigantic.
I'm going to play that right away here. But first we'll watch this first cutscene.
Oh, yeah. But remember, you're the bad guy. Don't feel good about what you've done.
Well, like Alex said, it's somewhat ambiguous because you do resurrect this girl.
That's true, but you're like releasing ancient gods or some shit, aren't you?
Okay, says, what's the other GTA? Yeah. I'm gonna play some
GTA 3.
This makes me want to play the remake even more, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can see that.
As it's one of those games that you can see the graphical abilities at the time just couldn't match what they were trying to do.
No, yeah.
At the time, it was impressive.
But like, it doesn't look that much different in my mind from how Ico looks.
I think a little bit, but Ico's so much smaller. They were able to just like play with the angles and the lighting so much more.
Yeah, that's fair.
That it still holds up a bit better than this. But that's why they remade it. Actually, first they remastered it, and then they remade it.
Right, there's a PS3 remaster that they released with Ico. They did a double remaster.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
Yeah, and then PS4, they did like... The people who are doing Demon's Souls now did the PS4 one.
Ah.
I guess that Blue Point game, they're like as good as it gets when it comes to remakes.
That's pretty awesome. I wouldn't mind being known for that as a development company.
Totally. Yeah, someone who will just like respect the original vision but make it like look amazing.
Yeah, exactly. See you, Tiny Observer.
They've done a bunch. I'll see you later, Tiny Observer. Have a wonderful
There's going to be quite a tone shift coming up. But yeah, that's Shadow of the Colossus. Like we said, hugely influential.
Now, does the tone shift have to do with Tiny Observer being here or not? Or
No, I meant we're going to be playing Grand Theft Auto next.
The cat's away, the mice are out to play.
Sure.
It's always been such a creepy sentence. I don't...
Was Demon's Souls the original Dark Souls game? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
But like,
that's how this game works. Every time you beat Colossi, you come back here, and then you just hold out your sword again.
Yeah, that temple reminds me a lot of the temple at the beginning of Zelda 2 that you wake up in, and Zelda's asleep in it, and
yeah, that's funny. Eh? Starts off this. Zelda inspiring this game, and then this game inspires Zelda.
Yeah. Whoa.
Comes around.
See, games are art.
There you go. This game proves it once and for all.
To be inspired, it has to be art.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it's 91% on Metacritic.
Wow.
And like, and because of stuff like the movies, like because of that movie Rain Over Me, and just because it, just because of its reputation, I know a lot of people that played this game that didn't really play anything else, like didn't really play games at the time even.
Yeah, totally.
They were also going to make a movie of this at one point, like a movie that's adapting wild. The game.
That doesn't make any sense to me, but.
Yeah, they had people attached to it too. I think the guy who directed that Fantastic Four remake that everyone hated.
Oh, I can't remember his name. Yeah. Josh Trank. Colin Trevorrow? Oh, Josh Trank. That's who it is. Yeah.
And then the director of Mama, Andres Muschietti, was going to do it at one point. But that was back in 2014, so I don't think.
I don't think anything's coming of that. But, I mean, they're making Uncharted now, so.
There you go. Maybe that'll just change start a new trend. The sword thing doesn't work anymore.
Oh, no.
Not that I thought that was the whole thing. Oh, there we go. Maybe somehow I don't know how I did that, but. Anyway, we're going to play GTA 3 anyway.
Oh, yeah, we were just talking about McKinley, that the whole time.
What we got? It says, man, oh, man, eating Pringles and beer is not a good choice. He likes...
What? Those are fine together, aren't they?
I don't know. I'm not that big a fan of Pringles in general.
I mean, Pringles are the weirdest potato chip because they're made of mashed up potatoes. Like, they're not made of cut potatoes. And then, like, the crazy thing, in the manufacturing process, any broken Pringles, they just put back into a vat and ground up to make new Pringles. Like, it's without a doubt the worst chip.
I was only half listening to that, but it sounded pretty disturbing.
It's not
great.
Vats
of Pringles. Sorry, yeah. I was just listening. I was reading. McKinley asked, does GTA 3 have any fun torture levels like GTA 5? But
oh God,
says,
I don't
no,
care.
But it has a sniper mission that everyone fails on their first try.
Yeah.
But like I says, like, Pringles are so salty, you need another beer, and the beer, you just eat more Pringles. That's how they get you.
That's how they get you. It's all a ploy and a sham.
But that's, we're actually working with Pringles and the beer company.
We're with Big Chip.
To keep you eating and drinking and watching this show. So keep eating and drinking Pringles.
Watching this show.
We'll be right back. We just got to switch games. And then we'll be back.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. We're back. Hey, everybody.
We're back. We're all just learning about each other today. Weird.
Whoops, we're about to change the games on my screen here. Give me a second here. This game takes forever to load anyway.
It always has.
Great music. It's Grand Theft Auto 3.
Yeah. Man, what's the name of the character in this? Who do you play?
You play as his name is Claude. Yeah.
Right.
But apparently, you didn't know his name in this game at all until San Andreas.
Right.
He appears in that game and he's named Claude.
You still got, what's it called, showing behind your head?
No, I just changed
there
that.
Oh, you did change. Okay, right. I'm just half a minute behind.
But this, I had to change the title, though, still.
I can do that. I'm in the app.
Oh, I'm already there.
You're already there.
I did San Andreas by accident, though. Three. There we go. Oh, yeah, I forgot to share the screen, too.
Yeah, I've just been getting by on the half-hour delay.
Half-hour?
Yeah, the half-minute delay. It's weird. I actually remember actively hating the soundtrack in this game when it was out at the time.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's surprising.
Like, well, because it wasn't quite licensed music, and if it wasn't licensed, well, it must not be any good then. I don't know. Like, I'm not saying it was a good opinion.
I don't remember at all, really, what the, yeah. Like,
yeah.
I really remember GTA soundtracks once I hit Vice City is like the first super memorable one for me. But it's interesting. I had people commenting about how much they loved the soundtrack.
Soundtrack, right. Whereas, the Vice City.
And I like that intro.
So good.
Yeah, totally. Well, after Vice City onward, they're just like legendarily good.
Right, yeah.
Well,
although 4 has a less amazing soundtrack.
Oh, did I miss something?
What?
Uh-oh.
Oh, like a loading screen or something?
Maybe it just loaded a game because I have a bunch of money. Yeah.
Sweet.
No, but I was hoping to see the beginning. Here we go. I think I have to go into the game. I do remember that being a thing with Grand Theft Auto games where you like it just loads the last one.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Oh, here we go. Yeah, like this is cool music.
And yeah,
this is really good.
I can barely hear. Let me hold this up to my ear. In 30 seconds.
I need to turn it up? Maybe I should turn the game up. You're just small time. Criminal shot. Oh, right. And so it's about your girlfriend just framed us or something?
I don't remember this at all.
Or left us for dead? I don't know.
That's wild. Yeah, this is all new to me.
Revenge, I betrayed him and left him for dead during a bank robbery. Yeah, that's what just happened. We made the papers even. Liberty City is in shock today as the police and emergency services deal with the aftermath of a devastating attack on a police convoy this morning. As yet, no details have been released about the prisoners being transferred in the convoy, and no group has claimed responsibility. The convoy left police headquarters early this morning for a routine transfer of felons to Liberty Penitentiary. The attack took place on the Callahan Bridge. This is stupid Carol Baskin. It's always Carol Baskin. Severely damaged. Some of the convicts are thought to have perished in the explosion that followed the initial attack. One of her tigers.
Did you see the other guy from Tiger King got arrested last week, didn't he?
Yeah, but that was like the second time since the Tiger King. He obviously should be.
Oh, yeah, there. All of the people. All be arrested.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh. Are they still making the Nicolas Cage Tiger King show?
I think so, yeah.
I sure hope so.
Oh, did they just free me?
Oh.
Oh, no, they're playing on. I would stop paying attention. I was thinking of a Tiger King.
They should make a Tiger King game.
Totally. Oh, just freed myself.
Don't, you're a strong, independent person.
Oh. I go Lex Cage. He's a good actor, but he doesn't get this good script anymore. I think he seems to, at this point, I feel like he's leaning into the crazy.
Well, and he does do a lot of very good movies still.
What?
He does. Nicolas Cage still does do a lot of really good movies.
Well, I guess, yeah. But I mean, I guess he means...
He's just less discerning. I think he's got money problems. It's the kind of actor.
Yeah, maybe it's just totally random.
Yeah, because like I didn't like it, but people really love The Color Out of Space.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
And I thought Mom and Dad was incredible. Like, there's.
Yeah, well, Mandy was very critically loved as well.
Right. Mandy was a little too weird for me.
A little too weird for me. Now, but now it's like, I don't know, every project he gets announced now is just so insane. We're just getting into it, which is great. Like, there was a shot of him in like a completely insane outfit that people compare to Travis from No More Heroes.
Oh. What?
Yeah.
Crazy.
And so people want him to play Travis. All right, there's like an opera station.
Oh, weird. We can ask if Nicolas Cage is the guy from that meme / Vine with the bees. I mean, yeah, among other yeah. things.
Yeah, among other memes.
Yeah. I like, even a lot of his bad movies I love. Like, he's so nuts. Did you ever see Drive Angry?
No.
He's such a gross, gross man in that movie. But it's great.
Oh, man, like, Bad Lieutenant.
I have a hard time watching that movie.
Oh, that's crazy.
Those are some... He is a bad, bad person. He's worse than Bad Santa and Bad Teacher combined, is how bad he is.
Yeah, it makes sense. He's a bad lieutenant.
Yeah.
He's got a position of power in the bad community.
Yeah.
Oh, whoops.
We need Bad Presidents, the movie. I mean, that's definitely...
Yeah, no, that's just too... I don't think...
We're living in that reality.
Yeah, you can't beat it either.
Oh. Oh, man, but when people do start having to go more extreme than this for the sake of drama, that's going to be some entertaining TV presidents.
Man, it's a Luigi's Club. Tiny Observer's Bag, did I miss much? Nope.
Nope.
Game Changers, we were tricked by a chick, and it's about Cage. We're just talking about Nicolas Cage. Actually,
yeah,
we barely even talked... About Grand Theft Auto 3 so far, but who doesn't know about Grand Theft Auto 3?
Exactly. Everyone played it.
Ridiculously successful and influential. Yeah. It popularized the sandbox genre. Maybe you could do me a favor. Open world, basically. And pick up Misty from the basically popularized the open world games.
Remember,
which is still probably the number one style of game.
So keep your hands on the wheel. If you don't mess this up, maybe there'll be more work for you. Now get out of here.
Came out October 22nd, 2001. Which, you might take note, is... Very soon after September 11th, 2001.
This is true.
Just over a month after. And it was delayed because of that. It was supposed to come out in late September. But they made a bunch of edits and stuff because of that. I just realized that both of our games today have connections to September 11th.
What's this game's connection is that it's a week or a month after September
11th? And it was edited because of September 11th.
What did they take out of it?
They changed the cars because they were a little too close to New York cars. They got rid of a mission with terrorists.
Interesting.
There's a few changes that are debatable whether they were like because of September 11th or not, but
right.
It was delayed. Because of that. And actually, the main change that definitely Rockstar acknowledges was that the cover art was changed. It was way more of like a, it looked kind of like a Grindhouse movie.
And
it
was cool.
Like explosive. There's a giant explosion in the background.
Interesting. And that, because then from GTA 3 onward, they all have the same cover art.
That's a pretty big choice. They changed it to this. Well, it's above me now. Yeah. All, and apparently just everyone instantly loved it. And that's like on the team, on the development team.
Totally.
And that's been the style ever since.
You can figure out everything you're going to get from this game looking at that cover.
Yeah, it's true. And that's, it has a great, it's an open world game where a whole bunch of, you meet all these crazy different characters and go to all these
driving. Murder and
areas, and you got a helicopter on there and a bridge and stuff. It just a boat. It definitely suggests that there's going to be it represents the game well. Is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, totally does.
What do we got here?
It's 3, the one with the cheat that makes everyone fight each other. I think they had that at San Andreas and Vice City as well, but there's one where he made an improvised battle royale with that code. It's another one that gives everyone rocket launchers.
We're gonna get some cheats going at some point for sure. Matt Lacko says, back then I bought some expensive RAM for my PC only to play this game. That's awesome. This CPU is too slow. That's fantastic. Yeah, it came out of Windows not long after.
I made my parents upgrade our computer to play Diablo 2, and it still didn't run. I remember. It's such a bad feeling.
I remember this was the second game I bought on the PS2. And it was definitely not the kind of game I would normally play. But it just, I had heard so many different things. And it was just so fun.
It's pure fun. Yeah.
Like,
more than the current games by far.
I don't know about that. They're
I feel like in the current games they do a lot of what the Red Dead thing is, where they get in your way a lot.
Probably. 5, not so much.
I didn't play much 5. Yeah.
5 was better for that. 4 for sure. But they're all fun. I always enjoy it.
Yeah.
Oh, so Lacko didn't play it on PC, but he played it on Xbox, I guess? Because when they came out with Double Pack? Yeah, I remember that. The pharmaceutical scientist is going to get you, Pogo. Oh, what did Shadow of the Colossus change? No, Shadow of the Colossus didn't change anything. It was just in a movie about September 11th.
Yeah.
Where it played like a pivotal role in the plot.
It sounds like a terrible movie to me.
It always sounded super sappy and emotional. You got good reviews, they say. Who knows? Adam Sandler. It's weird that Adam Sandler was the lead as well. It's just a weird. Yeah, it's weird. I did not consider that when I started this stream. Luigi said so that I'd have to talk about September 11th twice. Yeah, take it.
There's a new high on the street. Goes by the name of Spank. Some wise guy. Been introducing this trash to my girl.
Obviously, this game was very inspired by mobster movies, you can tell. Just by listening to it for 2 seconds, it's like spray it. I want Goodfellas. Apparently, one of the producers basically described it as Goodfellas, but an RPG.
I guess this game, like, I never would have saw it. Well, I would have seen it eventually, but this game motivated me to see Goodfellas and Scarface and all those.
Yeah, probably.
It kind of started the new, like, crime wave in our generation, at least.
Yeah, totally. Godfather. Tyler versus Pogo the Monkey? I wasn't even listening, but probably. Do I have to go beat somebody named Pogo the Monkey? But I'm assuming it's a guy dressed as a monkey.
Yeah, absolutely.
I wouldn't actually beat up a monkey. That would be horrible. Okay, so this is an RPG? Not really. But it's got, like, stats, I guess. I don't know. It's not really an RPG.
No.
But that's just how he described it.
They add a lot more RPG stuff in San Andreas once you get there. Because remember, you could make CJ fat or thin, and you had to, like, lift weights to make him stronger. And
but, like, so what's... Yeah. Well, like, what's that means? Like, I just realized I should... Like, maybe some of this is licensed.
I don't know.
Because I don't know, there was like some 80s sounding music there.
But not something you're familiar with.
No, I didn't recognize it.
That means it can't be licensed.
There's a chat station. There's a ton of dialogue. I think they wrote way more dialogue than they had ever written before. I mean, some of these. One of the writers figured around 18,000 lines were recorded because they also wanted to record tons of stuff for the pedestrians too, which they'd never done before.
Right.
Oh, whoops. Oh, am I fighting this person? Oh, Pogo, the monkey. Oh, did I just kill him? I think I killed him. Oh, I gotta take his car. Whoops. McKinley says, is there a way to put on your seatbelt so your character doesn't go flying when you crash at high speeds? I don't think so. I love that, though. I love that addition. That doesn't happen in this one.
Yeah,
like I said, the Xbox version was better. It had weather effects when it's raining and stuff. I can't remember if this one did or not. But I'm sure it looked better on the Xbox.
Totally. That's the version I had. I remember getting the double pack.
Does Twitch not allow licensed music, asked Tiny Observer? No, it doesn't. And actually, apparently, I was reading, they just cracked down pretty hard on that.
Yeah, there was a whole bunch of DMCA notices.
Yeah, they just decided recently that it's... Like, they apparently they don't even, like, I guess you used to have the choice to, like, whatever, like, take issue with it and argue it. You could argue the
right.
use of it, but now they don't even allow that. They just take it down instantly.
Huh.
Whoa, that was a sweet flip. I kind of wrecked this guy's car a little bit. That was a perfect insane stunt. I got a bonus for it.
For your perfection?
Yeah, insanity. Perfect insanity. Oh shit. This car is going to explode.
I don't remember having home bases in this game.
Yeah, I remember the look of that first one.
The more I see of this, the more I realize how little I remember.
Totally.
Yeah.
I think I played the other two like multiple times on the PS2. Vice City and San Andreas. But this, I think I only played once. Oh shit, again, I'm just on music that might be...
Oh, you should always switch to chat radio?
Yeah, exactly.
Car Gymnastics would be a very cool game, Tiny Observer. That would be... Dirt. I think Dirt 3, there was a mode in it called Gymkata, which was you driving, like, ridiculous little stunt courses in a gym and doing, like, crazy eights and donuts all over the place. That was pretty cool.
Oh, taxi. That was just uncalled for. All right, I did it. I got a sweet new car. It's almost on fire. I did it. Now I just have to go back to Luigi's.
You gotta go to Luigi's. But where's Mario?
Oh, I saw a guy dressed as Luigi with a sign telling people to go buy Halloween costumes.
I bet for the same Halloween costume store, a guy dressed as a giant dinosaur.
Probably.
Yep. Is it the one that's in the old hardware store?
They're pretty aggressive. I don't know where the old hardware store is.
The old Rona?
But I think
next to the Superstore, yeah. I don't see how you can fill a store that big with Halloween stuff.
Yeah.
Especially this, like, are people, is this going to be a huge Halloween or a tiny Halloween?
Maybe it'll be bigger because people are at home, so they buy more shit to put around their house to make it feel more Halloween.
Totally. And in theory, there's no reason kids can't go out and collect candy, right?
Lots of places are advising not to.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I saw some article about, like, Hershey's made, like, a door, like a robot door that goes around and gives people candy.
Weird. Like, I would make my kids leave their candy outside for a few days afterwards. Because that's easy to convince a kid to do. With a bag of candy.
Yeah, that would end in tears.
Now just wait a few days.
Wow. Yeah, great job. What's a few days going to do?
How long does the virus stay alive on things? I thought it was 3 days.
Oh,
outside.
I don't know, maybe.
Yeah. So just do that. Leave it in a garage.
Just put it in a... Yeah, just...
Children will understand. If there's one thing I know about kids, it's that they're perfectly reasonable.
Yeah. Some action from his regular girl, Misty. Go pick McKinley remembers playing Grand Theft Auto Advance. That's Diablo type. Junkyard, you can bring that cars to in order to earn money. And make it quick. Joey ain't the kind you keep waiting. Remember? What was GTA Advance? I think it might have been like the one or two, but remake.
I think
it was top down, right, McKinley?
Yeah, it was definitely top down. Yeah, I think it must have been one. But remade, or a whole different game.
Interesting thing, so when they first started developing this game, it wasn't Liberty City. It was more of like a mishmash of like New York, but also LA, and like it had elements from like a bunch of different cities to make like more of like a generic American city in general. Whereas this, they decided they wanted to make like generic New York City, like specifically make it around, and also it has elements from like other cities similar to New York, like Chicago, that kind of deal. But
yeah,
they at some point decided to really. I guess because they decided like they could make more of a statement if they made it more of a specific place.
Right.
So in this, you can go. There's three areas. One section that represents like a more of a Brooklyn, Queens area, then a Manhattan area, and then like a suburbs, New Jersey area.
Yeah, I remember the third island being the worst part, like the worst island.
Yeah.
That's...
Yeah. Yeah. Where's my map anyway? I don't know where the map is. That's weird.
Oh, yeah. Select? I have no clue how this works. Do you have a cell phone in this game?
Maybe select. Nope. Whoa, select changes the view. And there's a top-down view. That's pretty hilarious.
Disco dance! Disco dance! Disco dance!
You can basically just play it like old Grand Theft Auto. Like I said, it depends. Some tracks okay with Twitch, others are not. They'll mute. Yeah, that's true. They'll just mute us if it comes up. If someone comes to my house trick-or-treating without a proper mask, I'm going to spray them with a pressure washer in the below-freezing weather.
See, that seems needlessly cruel. I just wouldn't answer my door because you live in the middle of the country. Fun, so though. Anyone who's coming to your house is crazy.
Fun. His sounds more fun, though.
For him, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, that's weird. Why isn't my map just in this menu?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Maybe I don't have a map, but I must.
Maybe you don't, because remember, this game came with a paper map.
That's true. They all did, though.
Did they all? Yeah.
But this was the first one, so they might have thought that was good enough.
Right.
No, I guess these are the weather effects.
Oh.
Pretty slick. Well, I can't remember what I was trying to do anymore. Doesn't matter, I'm trying to steal a car now.
Yeah, I can give you cheats anytime you're ready. I don't know how to enter them, but I have.
Sure.
Alright, let's see. Wanted level down, raise wanted level, improve your driving skills, pump up the gore. Are you in a spot where you can enter a code?
I don't know. What is this? Am I on a mission? I think I'm on a mission. Never mind.
Okay. Now that I mentioned the word pump up the gore, I'm sure McKinley won't shut up about it, so...
The big controversy, of course, there's many big controversies, but... One of the big ones that I remember hearing about immediately was that you could have sex with a prostitute.
Oh, yeah.
And you could kill her and get your money back.
Yeah, that was the thing that made them. That was. Oh, what was the guy's name? Shit, Jack Thompson.
It was interesting. Like, Jack Thompson definitely had a crusade against Grand Theft Auto, but I guess with this one, there was kids. I don't know how old they were. They were teenagers, I think. But they killed some other kids, and basically said that they were inspired by Grand Theft Auto. Families sued Grand Theft Auto.
Oh.
And Jack Thompson represented them.
Interesting. So he was around forever.
It's like the start of their feud.
Weird. Jack Thompson versus video game.
But this game, I think it was that prostitute back, got this game banned in Australia.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, and they actually recalled all of it and sent out a new version that's edited where you can't have sex with prostitutes.
Oh, what a great version. How do you get your health back?
Nobody. That was like the worst possible way to actually get your health back.
It totally was.
It was like not actually feasible at all, really.
Joey!
I'll be with you in a minute, spark plug.
Yeah, Zero was actually, like I said, they recalled it and put out a new version, but Australia, it was like, nope. Don't fly in these lands. But yeah, the biggest hurdle for the development team and just making it was just making it all 3D. That was the first time they had to do it. Like I said, it made a huge impact on the sound as well.
Right.
Yeah, so they decided to record all the pedestrians as well. Wow, that's a huge moon. All right, isn't this the one where I can shoot?
I think so, but you might need a sniper rifle to do it. I can't remember. I remember how it worked exactly.
Hazard says, because of sex? Yeah, I guess. It's because you could still murder the prostitutes.
Yeah, you could still run everybody down.
Yeah, you just couldn't have sex with them first. I think it was, I feel like it was the combo that was most offensive to Australia.
Right. But, like, in theory, if you went into a store in this game and bought something, you could also go and shoot them and get your money back. Like, prostitutes were just another form of store.
It's true.
Yeah.
But maybe, but if it, I don't know, maybe they would have been fine with prostitutes you couldn't murder. It's hard to
say. You could just have sex with, yeah.
I don't know, maybe they're...
But then that might not have been okay in certain countries. Like, it's going to get banned somewhere no matter what.
Yeah, it's true.
Some places don't like sex, some places don't like violence.
Oh, I did.
And some places like a weird combination of sexual violence. So, you know.
You gotta... This game appeals to them all. I don't know. I don't think it actually has.
No, it really doesn't.
Any, like, actual sexual.
No, not at all. I think the hot coffee mod is as close as they ever actually got. Although that was just a sex mod game, wasn't it? I don't even know.
Yeah, I don't think that was violent.
No. Literally, I don't know. Like, yeah, what was people's problem?
Even this was quite offensive to people. The fact that I could just drive around hitting people.
Yeah,
I remember people asking me, like asking me to show them this game because they had just heard stuff about it. They wanted to see if it was like as horrible as. And generally, they were not offended. I mean, it's ultimately your choice how horrible you want to be.
Oh yeah, you don't have to be that horrible at all.
If you try to follow the traffic.
Although, that was always the thing, like, or they tried to go that way with GTA 4, where they were like, you were Nico and you were trying to like turn your life around and live the straight and narrow again. And you definitely couldn't do that.
But you can't play the main game and not
no,
do all the
and not
sure.
Murder a lot of people.
Yeah.
It would be weird if they ever make a GTA game where you can play like the pacifist.
That would be weird.
More, I don't know what to do.
You have more choice on the story.
Yeah.
This game was great. Like, yeah. It's interesting going back to this. Like, it's instantly, the physics are just fun to mess around with. Even back here. Like, they got it right off the bat. That's awesome. Now I'm on fire. Oh, no, I'm dead. Yeah. Oh, I'm wasted. All right, now I can do some cheats.
Sure, I'm ready. Do you want to pump up the gore?
Not really.
Okay. Well, then, are you out of a car? Are you? I think it says enter the following code during gameplay. I don't know what that really.
Oh, it's telling me about the hospital.
Okay. Poor Claude. All right. Tell me when you're ready for the cheat.
All right. I'm in gameplay.
Okay. Square L1.
Oh, wait. No. Now I'm going to get more gameplay going. I'm on top of this car. All right.
You got to get more gameplay. Okay. Square L1. Circle down. L1, R1. Triangle right. L1, X. I don't know if anything happened.
Didn't seem like it. What's
okay? Let's
to do?
Try. That was pump up the gore. Okay, oh. This one will be able to tell immediately if it works.
All
right. So, right, down, left, up.
Oh wait.
L1.
Right,
okay.
Down, left, up. L1.
L1. L2. Up,
oh,
left.
Shit. I screwed it up.
Down, right. Okay. Right, down, left, up. L1. L2. Up, left, down, right.
Like up and left.
Up and then left.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Cheat activated. That time.
Did you change costumes?
Yeah. Who am I? I'm a police officer.
Oh, cool. Okay. Here we go. This is a fun one. Down, up, left, up, X, R1, R2, L2, L1.
Well, shit. I screwed up.
Okay. Down, up, left, up, X, R1, R2. L2, L1.
Alright, what did it do? Oh, I just gave somebody I gave another police officer the finger.
Nice. That's the riot chief. So I don't know.
Oh. Everyone's going crazy? Yep, they're all fighting. There you go, McKinley.
Okay. It's weird. There's also a pedestrian's fight cheat and a pedestrian's gun.
Wow. He ran right through those guys.
Oh, this game. Okay. Okay, here we go. You ready for another?
Sure.
R2, R2, L1, R2, left down, right up, left down, right up.
Oh, nice. I know I switch weapons. Oh,
I don't
know.
There
we go, R2 and L2. Got it. Molotov. And I don't know how to use weapons either.
Yeah, that's a great question.
Oh, there we go. Flamethrower. Set that car on fire.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Molotovs. Oh. Grenades. Should I have like a bazooka? Yeah. Screw off, man. What? What? How do I use the bazooka? Is there a way to aim?
That's it. Not just L2. I have no clue. There must be.
L2 and R2 changed weapons.
Huh.
I thought it'd be L1.
Yeah, maybe.
Work. It doesn't work though. Can I hold down? Nope. Because I can't just. Usually I can just press circle to shoot.
Right.
Like with this. Yeah. Now. You run? Oh, yeah.
I can't remember.
Alright, go, man, go. We got the Triad Fish Band. Some awesome electronic music. Whoa! What the hell? What was that other Triad Fish Band doing?
So that's what it's gonna look like on election day in November. Oh my god. I hate that you're right. And I hate that we're so close to where that is.
That extreme right here.
Yeah.
I know it's terrifying how close it all is.
It's true. We've never been closer to experiencing like a civil war.
Not even in our country.
Thank goodness it's not our own, yeah.
Anyway. What else you got?
There's not really any more that sound interesting. There's one to destroy all cars.
nothing that brings me awesome cars.
I can get you a tank.
There you go.
Alright. Circle, 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 circle. Circle, circle, R1, L2, L1, triangle, circle, triangle.
Oh!
Did it work?
Yeah, it just like fell on me.
I didn't know what that sound meant.
There we go.
Yeah, that's like basic. Like, I can get you money, but I don't know what money would do. What point money would be for you.
Oh, yeah.
I can raise your wanted level.
I can do that on my own, thanks.
Yeah, you got a tank now. Does the tank have unlimited ammo?
Yeah.
Sweet.
That car, yeah, the tanks, always been amazing. Because the cop cars just drive into you and explode.
Just like real life. Flacco's next election is in September of 2021. Oh, I think ours isn't until at least 22, right?
Yeah, I think so. Unless they call one.
They could do that. I mean, it's just going to switch back and forth. That's all it ever does.
Yeah.
The NDPs are never going to win, even though they should. And it just switches back and forth and back and forth and back and forth forever. That's all you need.
Oh yeah, here come the helicopters. And then we got four now.
How many does it go up to? 5?
I think it's, yeah, no, it's 6. 6 is when they bring in their own tanks. Ho, ho. Oh, they're just all kamikazes. They don't have to shoot at all. Oh, oh, oh.
GTA is great. It's always been great. What a stupid fucking thing.
This was, like, you kind of played Grand Theft Auto before this, right?
I played a lot of the demo for Grand Theft Auto 1 on PC. And that was just 5 minutes, and you could do whatever you could do in 5 minutes, right. And I just do that again and again.
I think I remember playing that with you, so you were showing me that.
Yeah, that was great. And then GTA 2, I had a friend who got that and played a lot of that.
Yeah. This was my first GTA, for sure.
But this was also a different thing.
It totally was. It was the first one I really heard of, like, as far as like, it being a game that you had to play.
Like, kind of the first open-world game I can think of. Because I don't really consider, like, Ocarina of Time open-world.
Yeah, like, definitely 3D, yeah. Like.
Yeah. And it kind of is what all games are now. It's exactly. Just a map with a bunch of markers on it, and you drive around that map and go to all the markers. Yeah.
Exactly. Like it had the game. The AAA gaming industry hasn't really changed that much since this game.
In 20 or 19 years.
Yeah. That's how huge this game is.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, it's also admittedly probably very difficult to evolve beyond. Like,
I
knew what
bigger influencers was like, just Assassin's Creed after that, but that also just
it was kind of just this, but with more side missions.
Oh shit, stuck on a pole. Oh, they got me. That doesn't make sense at all. They should at least have to climb up on the tank and open it up.
Yeah, definitely.
Is that the moon? Yeah, it's huge. How do they give me the weapon one again?
Yeah, oh, they took your weapon away.
I guess I should just write that down and grab it myself.
Okay. Let's see. Yeah, are you ready for it? Or are you just Googling it yourself?
Yeah, but say it though.
R2, R2, L1, R2. Left, down, right, up. Left, down, right, up.
Perfect. Yeah, I got it.
That's the only one. Unless you want the tank one again, too.
Maybe, but that's the only one. There's only so much you can do with the tank.
Totally. I can also restore your health. There doesn't seem to be invincible, which is weird.
That is weird, yeah.
I can give you unlimited ammo if you're running out of ammo.
Yeah, McKinley says the game's actually lagging when the cars explode. Yeah, I think it is. Like I said, it hasn't aged well, but it's part of game history.
I don't think it looks so bad.
Parts of it haven't aged well, for sure.
It's easier to look at the Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although
it's got more color. That's the color aged well in this generation.
Yeah, oh, totally. It's weird, like, this looks a lot like State of Emergency.
Well, that was isn't that another Rockstar game?
Yeah, it was.
But it was Rockstar published.
Right.
Whoa! Yeah. That's more good stuff. But yeah, that was another game. And they took advantage of the Grand Theft Auto praise. Alright, now I'm doing pandemic missions. Whoops.
Oh no.
I clicked in a button. But now I'm going over the bridge. Can I do this? Oh no, it's... Oh! don't think my ambulance is going to save me. Oh, I think your headphones are dying or something?
Yep, they sure are.
Sure did.
Oh, yeah, I missed that comment earlier. Lacko wants more racing games on the show. So we have to, neither of us are huge racing games fans.
Huge racing games fan.
We've done a few of them. Uh-oh, now coming through your speakers.
Speakers. Yeah, my headphones are just fully dead. I don't know what's going on.
Oh, no. We played some. We played some Wipeout. We played some F-Zero.
There's only like three good racing games that I would like ever like prefer to play over other games.
Pretty much. Yeah, Burnout. Or
Burnout Paradise is like a great fucking game.
Yeah,
sort of, but I don't even like the recent ones at all, really. I tried starting that new Need for Speed that was free on PlayStation Plus, and I just don't like it at all. Tiny Observer says, please say Mario Kart.
Yeah, Mario Kart's pretty much the only racing game that I've played. But then Burnout as well.
And Mario Kart lost me at Double Dash for the most part. Yeah, there's not a lot. It's weird. I like Need for Speed Underground 2 a lot. That was fun.
Pretty sun effects.
Very.
Apparently they had a hard time fitting all of it onto a PlayStation disc. All of this, though. Like, there's still some strange sound. Yeah, we're getting doubles of, like, both of us.
I don't know why we're getting doubles. Yeah, I have no idea. If I could just get my headphones to charge again.
I'm just fighting with this taxi driver. Yeah, I'm trying to stay like a little bit further away from the mic so that I'm a little quieter out. Maybe you just lower my volume a bit on your end, Grimpen.
No, I can't.
No. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if there's anything we can do. It's the fun of streaming. Did you see, speaking of politics and the election, Alexandria Ocasio Cortez streamed on Twitch.
She's like the third biggest streamer of all time now.
Yeah, brought in like 400,000 viewers.
That's crazy. I mean, hopefully she convinces people, but that stream's not going to convince anybody to vote Biden. Most people are all voting Biden already.
I got a little
business to take care of.
I got a little job for you, pal. Because if you don't, it is pretty crazy how many people. Now, I guess other. It's crazy how like Twitch is becoming a platform for celebrities a bit now too.
Yeah, totally.
Like, I guess now other politicians are looking into it.
Of course they are.
But I guess Borat's going to be streaming soon, apparently too.
When you say Borat, you mean Sacha Baron Cohen's character, or he's
Yeah. I mean Borat.
Weird. Wasn't he making a new Borat movie?
Yeah, that's what it's a promotion of. Yeah, it's coming out.
Oh, okay. Right. I mean, that could be fun. I remember
lots of trailers for that, actually. Lots. It's promoted. It's been promoted a lot.
I was barely aware it was coming, so that's neat. I like promotion like that, though. That'll be hilarious streams, probably.
Yeah, probably.
And then, like, I remember when Will Ferrell was promoting the second Anchorman movie, and he went around to TSN during, like, a curling tournament, and he called a full game of curling, and it was amazing.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
That's genius.
I just want more of that happening.
That's brilliant promotion.
Totally.
Times versus AOC is queen. Did you watch her stream? I actually like I just happened, like, I knew she was streaming, but then I was just looking at her website, and it was like, her stream starts at this time. And I was like, oh, I wonder if that, what that is with the time change. And so I just clicked on the link, and it said starting soon, and then it started. Like, I just happened to hit the beginning of it, but then I only watched for like 5 minutes.
I sure can't with Among Us. I don't care at all to watch that, really.
Yeah, actually, I wouldn't mind watching a little bit just to have more of an idea of what the hell is happening.
Yeah, I suppose. I don't know what game I'd want to watch her play.
She also had like other streamers, which I did.
Yeah, she had like Pokimane.
She at the very beginning, she couldn't get her sound to work, and I was like, "Yep,
that's great.
That's streaming." Yeah.
But then, like, okay, maybe. She's also an expert politician. How much you want to bet she was doing that to endear herself to us? Be like, oh, streamers are going to like it because they're all going to identify with this.
No way she thought that through.
I'm just very cynical.
I hear in streamer culture that...
they hate OBS.
They, oh, nothing works all the time, so I'm going to make sure nothing works right off the bat.
Yeah.
No, I'm pretty sure that's just... Well, I think it's everyone with social distance, too, so she's like, oh,
oh, right. Oh, was she, like, with other people, though? Like, she was with those other... Well, you say when she was on her own...
She was talking at her to other people. And she had, like, a staff of people that were still doing all her tech, I'm sure. But they're just not in the room.
Right. That makes sense.
Like I said, there's the restaurant from the PSP game where you borrow the van. That's cool. They did bring back, like, the Liberty City. This was the first time they had Liberty City in the games.
Oh, yeah.
Back in a bunch of them. Came back. Oh, wait, no, sorry. It was in Grand Theft Auto 1 as well.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But it was this city. It wasn't, like, identifiable as the same city from GTA 1.
Right.
Other than that it had the name Liberty City.
Yeah, I think basically once they decided it was going to be New York, they just went back and like, well, let's actually make Liberty City from GTA 1 into like the actual thing.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, times there's a Jacksepticeye and Pokey. They streamed with them. Yeah, I didn't watch that. I didn't watch much. But, yeah, there was like a ridiculous amount of people watching. It was pretty crazy.
It's nuts. I mean, she's not as big as Travis Banks. Or no, Tyler, the Creator, rather. Or whoever it was.
What is the most? Drake and Ninja, probably? Or something like that?
Drake and Ninja was number one, and then the Fortnite thing was the other, yeah.
Oh, that's the... I see.
I can't remember. Was it Travis...
Or whatever was it Travis that... Spider? I don't know either of those people.
I would recognize the people, but I don't think I could identify any of their music. Like, did you see the whole stupid Travis Scott McDonald's meal?
No.
It was just a normal McDonald's meal, except like it was a Big Mac combo, except with your fries you got a thing of barbecue sauce.
Oh.
And he, like, branded it. Like, it's insane that this exists.
It is insane. Is he going to use bathwater? No. No Pokemon.
No, that was... I think that was more of an OnlyFans person or something.
Aga says, in Germany, some TV stars started to stream because of Corona. Yeah, I guess it's mostly because of the virus. That's why it's becoming big with celebrities and stuff. And musicians and, like, and TV stars.
Not even games. Like, a lot of them just, like, have, like, a little talk show, too.
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, they make their money live on stage doing stuff.
Yeah.
Doing appearances and stuff. Mostly comedians, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And all the, like, British panel shows, they all have their own weird streams now. And
but, like I said, the funny thing is now they're all gamers. Before it was, like, gaming, I don't do this stuff. But now they're all... It's because, like, yeah, it's... There's something for everybody now.
Yeah. Totally.
It's Among Us is pretty crazy for how universal, like almost anybody.
That's true, because there's not much that's there.
Yeah, there's not much to do.
Yeah.
yeah, it's like, yeah, phones. Like started with, I guess it started with the Wii and then phones, and it's like everybody's playing. There's something for everybody now. I'll find something to destroy.
Not for me. I only want to play with my stick and ball.
There's no way. About obscure, weird stuff that has aged badly and controls. Yeah. Bad controls.
Well, giving up on that stuff. Give me my stick and ball. Those, the controls on that are the worst. It'd be weird to make a site that reviews like classic children's games. Today we're reviewing Ring Around the Roses. Got a really hard initial difficulty curve.
Hey, but... GTA is awesome. 5,000. Do I have money to get a plane ticket and come to New York City and get a pizza?
Absolutely. If you front me the cash, I'll pay you back. I swear.
Yeah, we got the money. Just
not in liquid funds. We just need to.
Yeah, we gotta make some things liquid.
Yeah. So yeah, you just if you just I'll give you my bank account info. You just put the money in my account. Then I'll take a pizza with you. I bet pizza does taste better in New York.
Get hit with licensing stuff.
Yeah. It's dead.
I had to wait till it was dead. Forever.
GTA is awesome claims that pizza is good in Brooklyn. Whoa. Yeah, I want to buy like one of those pieces of pizza that's like a foot across and have to fold it in half.
Oh, yeah. I know. Yeah. I've never been to Brooklyn or New York at all, I should say.
And then I need to eat in, what's the deli that everyone eats at? Schwartz's Deli? No. Is that what it's called? Katz's Deli. It's Katz's Deli.
I think Schwartz's Deli is in Montreal.
Montreal is
I've
the Schwartz.
I've been there, actually.
Yeah, me too. Katz's, I think, is the one. Did you see last week was the 20th anniversary of when Curb Your Enthusiasm started?
Oh, that's awesome.
That's bananas how long that show's been going, and it still sort of semi-regularly goes.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's always been semi-regular. Like,
right.
It's never really had a consistent season. Yeah, like, except maybe the first few. Like, they were regular seasons, but. Yeah, man. And there's a new one coming. Can't wait. Tiny Observer wants to visit New York someday, too. Let's all go to New York.
Mm-hmm. We're going to start, we're going to be like the next PAX. We're going to start Grimpen New York Expo.
Cop car. I'm a cop. It's okay, I'm a cop.
Yeah, it's a cop.
Oh.
This is a citizen's arrest.
Oh, man, these police officers. They just made the things hard for me. Okay. Because I gotta lose the cost before I can start the mission. It's a crazy world. Tiny Observer feel old.
Yeah. It really does.
Game
yeah.
history actually usually has that effect.
Yeah.
That's actually why we're playing GTA is Awesome 5000. That's why we're playing. Because it came out this week in gaming history.
Yeah. Every week gaming history is a stark reminder that we are no longer children.
Exactly. Especially this era. This is probably the most...
Yeah.
It ages us.
These are probably the games that influenced why I'm fucked up the way I am now.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh,
cops on. Black wants a gaming history where we can only choose racing games. Would that be possible? We don't own enough racing games between us.
Yeah, that's true. Probably. It's highly unlikely that there's a week with, like, two racing games.
They put out like a lot of games in the same series on the same days in different years, kind of. So there could be a week that's like Road Rash 1, 2, and 3. And that's, like Burnout 3 or something.
Maybe, yeah.
Classic racing. Like if there was Super Off-Road we could play that, we'd have access to. Or rock and roll racing.
Whoa, that's a tank.
Oh. Uh-oh. Why is there a tank around already?
Maybe it wasn't a tank. I can't quite tell. Everything's very dark. Whoa.
Anytime I see your character out of a car, you're just a black outline of a person.
Yeah, exactly. Dinosaur says somebody got blown out of a car earlier, and the physics were awesome. The physics are great in this game.
Yeah.
Like that, it's crazy, like I was saying, earlier, how instantly they got it right.
Totally. And that's the issue with GTA 4, is they stripped all the fun physics out.
Oh, the physics are so great in GTA 4. It's the car physics that are the worst in GTA 4.
It's just not fun to drive. Yeah.
But the physics are still generally so great. It just felt like in GTA 4 they made the crappier cars way crappier to drive.
Right. And then you only had crappy.
It's a good idea, but then at the beginning, you're getting nicely crappy cars.
It's driving shitty New York taxis around everywhere.
Yeah.
Going to see your cousin Roman. GTA also says New York City's pizza is worth every penny, but I bet pizza is the same price in New York as it is here, but just better. And pizza's already worth every penny. Pizza's great value for money.
That's true, actually.
Yeah. So imagine if you could have the best pizza you've ever had, but better, and for the same price.
Sounds great.
Sign me up.
Yeah.
We just have to figure out a way out to New York. Do you think people would pick up a hitchhiking monster?
Oh, shit. Yeah, probably, actually.
That'd be pretty cool. I can,
maybe not
I can give part. You a, I can get you a cheat that'll improve your driving skills.
Just keep, my aid help, I guess. I'm having some troubles. I keep getting one star, so I can't take any missions. And then I try to lose the star and then hit again.
I don't know if driving skills would help you with that.
Like I said, that's also cheating, though, because we're really good at road rash. Road rash skills are legendary.
Yeah, that's right. That's what Grimpen's known for, the Grimpen road rash speedrun scene.
I'm just making a break for it on foot. Go, man, go. Go, man, go. Go down the stairs. Oh, no. The gate. Can't lose this one star. Oh no. Cops found me. Yeah. Anyway. Hugely influential game, like we said before. Many times before. This game actually, though, so unlike Shadow of the Colossus that we've already said was a critical and commercial success, this game is like one of the greatest critical and commercial successes of all time. I remember, I used to always get Electronic Gaming Monthly. I'd get it every month.
Yeah.
And I remember they'd have a list of just the top 10 best-selling games of the month. And this was on it for what it felt like years and years. It sold insanely well. And it's at 97% on Metacritic. It's in the top
That's
five.
Crazy. Yeah. And it has so many reviews, too.
Best reviewed games of all times. Yeah, and it's insanely. Yeah, it's good. Great reviews of all. Okay, I just have to look to catch me again. Like, I loves the history. Yeah, the publisher didn't believe it would be a success like this. Yeah, no, they were just trying to translate Grand Theft Auto. Man, as soon as I start, this homeless guy just comes up and starts beating the shit out of me.
Well, that's the problem, is ultimately the people are on riot mode.
Oh, right. Everything's still... That's weird. Yeah. They took away my guns. But it left
true.
Everybody on riot mode.
Yeah, that's insane.
I stole a taxi and everybody...
And I don't know how to turn that off.
Yeah, that's what's happening. That's why people are just running into the streets. That makes more sense. One guy just ran into a car back there.
The car had it coming.
Try not to. Oh God, it's so much harder not to hit anybody. And all the four on the streets when you come by. Like, this is a, oh no, you know, to start the cheat but not how to turn it off. So we stop this crazy game. It's out of control.
That's the problem with cheating. Cheaters never prosper because they attain absolute power and then they go crazy and get corrupted by it.
You just can't lose this single star. Like, does it just not go away?
There's a cheat for lowering your wanted level.
Maybe I should.
Let me find it again. What? Did you hit a cop?
I got a marker that lowered it. But then I came out of the alley, I instantly hit another pedestrian. It got raised again. Okay, yeah, here, I'm gonna get in my car and just try to run to the place. But yeah, give me the code.
R2, R2, L1, R2, up, down, up, down, up, down.
There we go. Okay. Now I can just hopefully go to this mission. Unless they start punching me again.
When you gonna drill me?
In a moment, sweetheart. I got a little business to take care of. I got a little job for you, pal. The Ferrelli brothers have owed me money for too long.
The Ferrelli brothers.
Respect. Lips Ferrelli is stuffing his fat face in the St. Mark's Bistro, so steal
yeah,
his
sixth
car,
highest rated game, sir.
Eight Balls Bomb Shop
not
up in
Harlem.
Pretty good.
You sixth know Eight Ball, right? Game of
Once
all time.
With a bomb, go park the car where you found
better
it.
Than any game I've made.
Yep, I just remember that. Like, I would never have played a game like this at the time. Like you said earlier, it got us into crime movies and stuff again.
Got us, brought us into the world of crime.
Crime, yeah, we just got us into crime. And then, but that like you, I just had to play it. It was. Oh well, that's great shit. Stole a taxi, ran over somebody, and then hit a cop car. That's how I started this mission. Yeah, the Claude is a silent protagonist as well. Which is the only game that did that as well. Uh-oh. Yeah, I still don't know what's going on with the soundtrack. It's half the stream of the new.
Hooray!
I guess I just finished this mission.
I bet this is the first mission in the game, isn't it?
No, I think I did. I've got a couple. No, I've gotten a bunch. I got enough that I have two mission sources now.
Oh, crazy.
Oh, but the cops got me.
Busted. I bet just having... it would be an interesting challenge to beat this whole game with Riot mode on.
It's harder, for sure.
Yeah.
Like, it's almost impossible not to get the cops on you.
Yeah. You just have to get really good at avoiding them.
Diving in front of your car. You're not respecting the costume.
No, they really should.
I am the police.
The uniform. Tiny Observer asked, says they missed the beginning. Can you choose your own character? No, you always play as this dude. Well,
yeah,
not
but
this dude. This dude's a cop.
Actually, yeah, when we were typing in cheats, one of the cheats was that we could change our costume. So that's why I'm like a police officer. Yeah. but no. Usually you play as just a monster looking guy named Claude. Okay, no cops this time? Shit! You guys can't steal vehicles.
Because they just get on you the second you do?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
Running into my car.
It's like World War Z or something.
Okay, go, man. Go, 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 go. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Maybe I can't do this mission. I have to keep this vehicle in good condition.
Oh my god.
I have to go get it repaired now.
That sounds impossible.
Oh shit.
But I mean, you like a challenge.
Oh no, now I have 2 stars. But I think they'll lose. I'll lose them for once I get this repaired.
Probably,
shit,
yeah.
I just missed the turn off. Whoa, that'll work. Oh no, 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 there's a cop right there. Oh, that sucks. There's no way. I was already way out of there.
This is an insane, yeah. I feel like this is probably impossible. No. No, if you just keep slamming your head.
Yeah. Oh, there's so many bombs. Start beating the shit out of me.
You can never have too many bums, is what I always say.
Yeah, GTA always has set characters. This was the only one with a silent character, so this is the only one that like maybe it could have worked if it was a female character.
Totally.
The other ones, yeah, they always have set characters. The Lacko recommends if you want a badass female character, try Wet on the 360.
What?
Do you remember that game?
Yes.
That is a really obscure suggestion there, Lacko.
I mean, it was when Bethesda was trying to become their own publisher for a little.
That's true. Yeah, that's some like early, some... like yeah.
But what? Didn't fucking Mila Jovovich voice Wet?
I remember.
It was, man, that is the least empowering thing. You know, she just slid everywhere.
Why is that was, not empowering?
Right, because she was just about.
Well, like I think it was regarded for having, or like a female character. Like it got a lot of praise for that, for the character. I can't remember.
I don't think so, but I don't know. Yeah, maybe, but I could be wrong. I don't know. Everybody loves Wet, apparently. Everybody loves Wet and Shadow of the Colossus. Yeah.
Oh no, they're gonna kill me.
That's what happens. This is gonna be a difficult mission to beat.
Oh, that's fine. I haven't thought about that game for a long time. When did that game come out?
Same year as Rogue Warrior, so that's probably like 2000.
Yeah, just like the.
Have you ever seen the credits for Rogue Warrior and heard the?
I Mickey believe I have.
Records
yeah.
A rap song for it where he talks about taking a snoop and a poop.
Yeah, I think I did. I watched. Yeah, Mickey Rourke. Right. Yeah, he's got a rap song. I think I watched it on YouTube.
Yeah. It's
yeah.
Nuts.
Another very. Yeah, those are just very obscure titles from that era.
I think they're like 2012, 2011, probably, yeah. Those are games that were all out when I was working at a game store, so I was able to actually try the trash. That was, like, I was able to try all the trash that was coming out at that point.
Right.
Which was, that was great. But, boy, there was some bad stuff. Remember Chrome Hands? That's how what cops do. Sounds like he's acting like a cop.
Oh, it's accurate portrayal. Uh-huh. Maybe I can't beat this mission. Okay, I'll try one more time.
I mean, I bet if we enter that riot code again, it'll stop the
probably.
Riot. But no, it's fine.
That'll take out the challenge.
Exactly.
Like I said, the graphics don't hold up so good for wet. That is interesting, though, that it's... Yeah, I forgot that it was Bethesda. That's somewhat notable. Oh, I can't do this mission?
See, like, if I'm playing a weird, somewhat bad shooter from that generation, the one I would probably go back to... Remember Stranglehold?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The John Woo game. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
That looked fun.
Yeah. You could slide down railings and shoot.
Yeah.
Man, I miss that generation.
Oh, graphics from the trailer he posted. And it's not from the game. The game still looks good.
The game's still beautiful.
Wet.
It's wet. I even hate the name Wet for a game.
It isn't a good name.
Oh, it's definitely very bad.
But I do love me some sliding mechanics.
Yeah, that's true. But you can't slide anywhere. It's not Vanquish.
I don't expect anything to be Vanquish.
You can't slide
every sliding
that
game. Far. I don't expect anything to match the sliding in Vanquish.
No one put rocket shoes on their sliders.
Exactly.
Rocket Shoe Sliders is just a great name for a game.
Alright, let's see if I can do this. Mike Lift Last Launch. That's a great name for a mission. Oh, God. I'm just instantly beating the shit out of me.
It's just too hard.
Okay, can I get a car? Out alerting the coppers. Remember learning in GTA, you always run down the... If you want a car, you run down the lane where the cars aren't coming towards you.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, the cars will just pass you in that lane. Like, oh shit, right. There's a car.
And they'll usually stop for you.
Yeah, exactly. In the late, I think in GTA 5 they don't really as much.
Right. That's crazy.
I think there's some of the music is licensed.
Huh. I haven't recognized the song yet, but that doesn't mean anything.
You just take these alleyways, there's like a... a wanted badge that takes away the wanted level.
They just put them just in out of the way places.
Oh god, but then people run on the road.
Mine is bigger. Stupid people, they just want you to be caught by the police.
Oh no, I trashed the vehicle. I didn't think that these things would trash it.
They trashed it. They're just a bunch of trashy people.
No, I meant the things that... These, like, barrier things. The people might have contributed to the trashing, though. The trash.
I mean, the barriers wouldn't exist if it weren't for the people.
Okay, here we go. There's a woman over there headbutting that man. Like I said, will we play the sniper mission? I don't think I'm gonna get there.
No, if you're having a hard time with this one.
Yeah, even the sniper mission that was notoriously hard.
Yeah,
There's been a few of those in Grand Theft Auto games.
Oh, the remote control mission.
I was gonna say, I don't think anything's the same as the Zero mission in GTA San Andreas.
Yeah. It's a terrible
control thing, and I beat that. So.
Yeah, I did too. But you just had to get to the point where you do it perfectly.
Yep. You just had to be completely perfect, and it was a nightmare.
Yeah. But you were doing it for David Cross, so it wasn't so bad.
That helped. I had to do all the missions because couldn't let David Cross down.
Oh, of course.
I have to drive so carefully.
Damn it, that car. But then couldn't someone just launch at you at any moment?
I don't think the people heard it enough to damage it. Maybe if enough of them. Did it.
Yes.
Oh shit, I wonder if this is licensed music. Damn.
Professional gamer. Look at you being a professional gamer.
Oh no,
gamer.
Park the. Whoa. why didn't I lose the cops? This is not over. Well, I'm only trying this one once.
Never over.
I don't know if I can hurt the car yet or not, so I'm just gonna not.
Just gonna be very careful.
Oh, Lack is pushing once again for his Barbie RPG game.
Yeah, I don't know if we have the ability to play it. Otherwise, we would have many times over. Because you claim it's always historic.
But Lack is excited for some gaming history. Yeah, few weeks because there's a shitload of games.
Exciting ones.
Oh no! Shake the cops and lose my wanted level.
Oh god.
Well, that's impossible.
I could list you off a cheat really quick.
Sure.
All right, let me get my telephone back.
Right up here. I only have a minute to beat this mission.
Oh, all right. R2, R2, L1, R2, up, down, up, down, up, down.
I did it.
Nice.
Okay, now back in the car. Cops are still playing with people. Good enough? Oh god, it's not good enough.
Not good enough.
We park it properly. Not weird person.
You're a valet.
Oh no, I just touched. Oh well, that's it.
There goes your friend. Not worth it.
Oh god.
That's a sucking nightmare.
I only have 10 seconds left.
I believe in you. You can get it repaired that quickly.
Oh, whoa. Wow. Too slow, man. Too slow.
Too slow, man.
Well, at least I did the part that I was trying.
Totally. I consider that you beat it.
Yep. Nailed it. Oh, there we go. I just saw the thing. Thanks for the follow, GTA's Awesome 5000.
Yeah.
Like I said, we played this in This Week in Gaming History. We do This Week in Gaming History every week. With a different set of games that we put on our social media accounts at It's Grimpen on Twitter and Instagram.
Yep.
You can go vote for those games every week. There's going to be a new set of games up tomorrow for next week.
Oh, boy.
And you'll be able to vote on those. As Lako said, it's starting to get good. End of October and early November. Man, it's like every day on these things in our notebook, it's just got like pages are filled. It's got so many games on each day.
Yeah. It's such a dumb industry where they like 80% of everything comes out in a 3-week span.
Yeah.
No, it's nuts.
Especially the more modern stuff. Yeah. Like the older stuff is more spread out, but
yeah.
And by the time this game was out, like, yeah.
Oh
like,
yeah.
This generation, like this is when it's like, it's all in this area. Yeah. Like it says, okay, I don't want to see racing games. I want to see parking games.
play some.
You got that today. Today was a parking.
Yeah, that, there's a parking today, and I've done some parking. I think Gran Turismo had some sweet parking.
Oh, you have to park in that?
Action. Yeah, well, you there's like a tutorial that you have to do, basically, that just like teaches you how to stop and start.
Yeah, but it's a racing game. Why do you need to know how to park?
Well, it's not parking. It's like stop and start. It's like you have to hit.
Why do you need to know how to stop it?
You have to. It is ridiculous, and you have to do it to get your license, to like level your license up. That's why I hated that game when I played it.
If I was teaching someone to drive, the one thing I wouldn't teach them is how to stop driving.
It's fun though. Like it'd be way more fun to practice in real life. But it's like it is. It's more of a thing where you have to like hit a certain speed.
Oh yeah,
and then stop and like stop within like a small area.
I see. Come to like a precise stop.
Yeah. Tiny Zeros would love to see another spooky game this month. There's probably something on in gaming history. I don't know.
Totally. Well, otherwise, we're playing Resident Evil 6 every Monday.
That's up to
Monday.
The gaming history fates. Mm-hmm. Olaga wants us to raid another stream. Oh no way.
No, we just way too much work.
Yeah, we're tired, Lago. You're drunk.
And you're drunk.
And you're drunk on Pringles.
That would be a pretty good thing to get drunk on. Like, because you'd be taking in matter as you drank, so you wouldn't get so hungover the next day.
Yep. It would help.
That's the way to do it.
But we're playing Resident Evil 6, though.
Yeah, that's spooky, I guess.
Yeah, we're playing that on Monday. So there'll be some spookiness as we get closer to Halloween.
Yeah, that's ultra spooky.
Yeah, no, that's at the end of the show. Unfortunately, we got stuff to do.
Like, not raiding.
Yeah. No, I got a bunch. I have stuff to do, including... Yeah. Getting his gaming history ready for tomorrow.
Oh man, I'm excited.
Oh, we made Lago sad, but he's okay.
I mean, life is all about learning to deal with disappointment.
Oh, peaks and troughs.
Peaks and troughs. And the thing is, you can't eat if you don't got a trough to eat out of.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Think about that. Yeah. Put that on a t-shirt.
Put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Danny Zuru might stop by on Monday. Cool. See you there.
Yeah.
And yeah, that'll be Monday. And then maybe we'll see you next week for some more gaming history, depending on the game.
Back
Hopefully
on Friday.
We'll see you there. And then, yeah, some crazy fun on Friday, as always. We might do some kind of Halloween thing next Friday. Oh, wait. All right. We still have this Friday to come, too.
Yeah, there's this Friday still. We still have a whole week before
that. We're playing Jackbox this Friday. More Jackbox 7. It was super fun last week. We're going to do more of it.
Ultra groovy.
Like I said, it's also kind of commercial for you, so yeah, it would be smart of us too, for sure.
Yeah, true. We just need to raid while we're playing a game, and our chat can just watch other people stream when we're doing boring things.
Oh no, don't worry. It's totally good to ask. You should probably encourage us.
I'm never not gonna be bitter either. So you know,
promote our stream, especially. I don't think there's anything you could do, Lako, that would make us think ill of you.
Oh, I thought that would make us think well of you.
Well, yeah.
Oh, snap.
You're right in the middle.
Yeah. You're unshakably in the middle.
Don't think either ill or well.
You are a valuable citizen.
No, it's a good idea. I do have stuff to do, and I'm also pretty tired as well.
We also don't even know how to do it. It would take figuring out.
I've never done it before either.
Do you really want me to just keep coming up with excuses?
Really stupid. Yeah, that's also dumb. Yeah, have a good night, Lako. Enjoy the rest of your Pringles.
Enjoy a delicious Bavarian brew on me.
And hopefully we'll see you soon. If not, soon. Friday for Jackbox, Monday for Resident Evil, or
Wednesday
for gaming history, because that's what we do here. Oh, Antsy Pants and his quarantine jam.
Oh, Lunar Gaming! Lunar Gaming! Lunar Gaming! Lunar Gaming!